Building in The Sims 4. I don't know how to title my stream. Idiot Simsy is simming. Yep. Okay, that'll work. Title updated. Fixed it. I'm sorry, I didn't fix my title for the stream, and then I went live, and I got really nervous because my stream didn't have a title, but I fixed it. Ah, so we're fine. It's fine. I think I'm gonna build in The Sims today. I'm kind of feeling it. I'm kind of feeling some Sims building. I don't know who's with me, but I'm ready. It's happening. Sims? The Sims? Simsy's playing The Sims? I know what you're thinking, and you're thinking, what? The Sims? And the answer to your question is yeah. Yeah. I think I'm gonna build today, like I said. I'm not super certain what I want to build, but like, we'll figure it out. Also, Discord partner, by the way. I don't know if you heard, but Discord partner, by the way. Discord partner, by the way. I'm just saying I'm a Discord partner, so you wish you were me. I also put on my eyebrows approximately 1 minute ago. I'm a couple minutes late to my stream because I was putting on my eyebrows. I forgot to put makeup on until 4 p.m. and I was like, oh my god. Like, I opened OBS and I saw and there was just no eyebrows and I was like, oh, right. We have to do that. So sorry I'm a couple minutes late. Could have been a disaster, but we fixed it. Also, hi, Hannah. How are you? Your birthday was yesterday. Hey, unicorn, what's up? Hi, birthday! A queen is never late. Everyone else is simply early. You know what I mean? Okay. Well, Lena, thank you for the 18-month resub. Thank you.
You're amazing, Illy, so much.
I love you, friend. I don't even look that bad, that eyebrows fan. I look the same. I streamed without any makeup on recently. It was a Simsy After Dark stream, like, a couple weeks ago. Maybe it was on Easter. I think it was on Easter. Because I got home, and I was alone. And I was lonely, and I was like, wow. And then I went live, but I didn't have any makeup on. Slept 1 hour, then 24 hours. Nice. Nice. But there was a couple days ago. Hey, Sims Obsessed. Hi, Rihanna. Hey, My Soul Melody, thank you for the bit. Thank you.
It's WHO's done with school until January. Whoop, whoop.
This is very exciting. You're so close. You have so much time. Nothing until January is a long time. Good luck and have fun, friend. Sleep in bakery.
Because my sweet mother oh, friend, I'm so sorry. Last month. Life has been crazy, but watching your VODs when I'm alone really helps me. Thank you, friend. I love you less than three.
I love you too, friend. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, but thank you for the 4 month resub. Man. Okay, I love you guys a lot. That's all. Thanks for listening. Yesterday we played City Skylines, for those of you guys that didn't know. Good stream. I'm getting so good at City Skylines. I owe my life to James Turner. Because the only City Skylines videos I ever watch are his, and then he was in my chat yesterday giving me advice about mods, and like, we'd be nowhere without him. To be honest, I wouldn't have even made Sims YouTube video. Okay, here's the tea about James Turner. I wouldn't even be making Sims content without James. And now all of a sudden he's like a City Skylines god too. Like, you don't get to have it all, James. But anyway, I owe my life to James Turner.
13 months.
So.
I actually get to watch the stream today calls in my work.
Fair and Moon, thank you for the 13-month resub. Thank you. And also, Chaos Killed the Dinosaurs, thank you for the 12-month resub. Oh my god. I was gonna say James Charles. I owe my life to James Charles, yeah. Sorry, did I say Turner? I meant Charles. James Charles. Alex, thank you for the 13-month resub. You're gonna do so good.
I feel like this is like the Thray and his basketball game XD. Anyway, love you, Kayla.
Alex, I'm so proud of you. You're gonna do awesome. Thank you. Yeah, oh, James Charles and his tour tickets. Daisy, thank you for the 17-month total resub. Oh my god. How are you, friend? It's good to see you. I love you too. If you guys missed it, James Charles was charging $500 for VIP meet and greet tickets. Which, to be honest, I'm not certain how I feel about that. Because, like, for one, you know, there's going to be a lot of people at his tour and stuff. But it just seems so much money. Noodle, thank you for the bit. Thank you. It's kind of wild, though. I checked when he posted his tickets. Like, he's coming to the Dr. Phillips Center in Orlando. So anyone who's around the Orlando area knows about that, maybe, potentially. That's, like, when... that's, like, the theater in Orlando. So, like, when, like, Hamilton came touring to Orlando, that's where it played. So, like, kind of a cool place. Like, that's kind of wild that James Charles is gonna be playing the Doctor... Playing. He's gonna be at the Dr. Phillips Center. You know? Like, that's kind of cool, isn't it? And maybe he's charging a lot of money. But, like, that's kind of cool. I don't know. Dr. Phillips Center? Like... Anyway, celebrities are kind of wild. The whole concept of that is ridiculous to me. Does anyone know how... Okay, I have a question. Like, an honest... Okay, but the thing is, Pike Sims, like, James Charles, while he's a beauty guru and not a real celebrity, I think that it's dumb that YouTubers aren't considered real celebrities. Like, James Charles is a huge deal. Right? But also, like, what's his tour gonna be? Like, to... I don't know. Either way. But, kind of cool that he's going on tour like that, and, like, I think he can... But people act like YouTubers aren't mainstream celebrities. Like, if a real celebrity, like, what's real, like, some person who made a movie went on tour and was charging meet and greet tickets, it'd be like, oh, well, they're a real celebrity. But James Charles gets 100 million views a month on YouTube. 100 million views a month, by the way, and he's not a real celebrity. Like, what does that even mean? But I don't know. I think it's really cool that James Charles is so young and so wildly successful. Like him or not, I think that's kind of cool. But anyway, you don't think Liza Koshy is a real celebrity? I think that she's a pretty big deal too. I think it's impossible to claim that James Charles isn't a real celebrity. Again, like, the guy's kind of famous. Austega, thank you for the 9-month resub. Hello, thank you so much for the 9-month resub. Slightly problematic, yeah. Respect his career, but not him. I mean, that's the thing, like, you don't have to like him, but I think you can admit the fact that he's very successful. And pretty talented, to be honest. Like, you don't get that successful without being pretty talented. I don't know. And he makes high-quality YouTube content. Chris, thank you for the 10-month resub! Thank you. I appreciate you a lot, friend. The Met Gala, I don't even want to talk about that. That whole concept is so weird to me. Because, like, people just pay all this money to go to the Met Gala and pay all this money to get fancy looks, and then all the people in the world and the internet just, like, judge them all. And, like, what a weird concept. It's kind of fun. But, like, how wild is that? Like, the Met Gala is a crazy thing, isn't it? I don't know. Okay, what am I building today? I have no idea. Would I charge five? See, the thing is, okay, Jules, I wouldn't charge any money for a meet and greet. Obviously, like, I'm not in a place where, because the reason that people charge money for that is when they have, like, people like James Charles, who are going to have so many people wanting it. Hey, Laura. You're
having a good day. I'm not many tears today, but I know your stream will
Laura,
make me
I'm
feel
so sorry.
Better. Simsy Hart.
I love you, friend. Thank you so much for the 3-month resub. I'm really sorry you're having a bad day. But, like, realistically, a person like James Charles, he can't meet everyone that comes to that tour. Like, he just can't. That's not gonna happen. There's no way. There's too many people that are gonna go to it. So he has to do something to distinguish, like, a VIP ticket to make it so that he has to meet less people. But I also don't think, like, I think he could sell a very limited number of VIP tickets, for not $500. I think that's a little bit expensive. But I do think that, like, charging more and charging a few hundred dollars is maybe reasonable. I don't know. It depends. I don't know. I wouldn't pay it to meet him, but I'm not, like, a James Charles stan. So, like, either way. Yikes, Mia. Thank you for the prime sub. I haven't been live for 4 hours. Mubat has some uptime issues recently. So. Okay, but the thing is, like, Jules, people like Ariana Grande and, like, other people, like, at concerts, meet and greet tickets can be, like, thousands of dollars. Like, I don't know. So, it's kind of wild. Like, how do you, like, cross that line? But they aren't? Well, sometimes they are. It depends. I can't even read your name on Twitch. I don't even know who... Sondra Lee. Dark mode. Can't read it. YouTubers charge more than celebrities. Who are you talking about? I'm not defending James Charles. $500 is a lot of money. No, I don't know about Ariana in particular, Hannah. I'm just thinking about, like, meet and greet tickets that I've seen. Like, concert tickets can be so expensive. And, like, fair. I don't know. It's... I don't know if JoJo charged, like, $5,000 once. Really? JoJo's audience are children. You can't... 150? I think that 150 is reasonable for Dan and Phil. Like, I think that $150 is a reasonable price for a meet and greet ticket. Like, I... Obviously, it's expensive still, but, like, it's Dan and Phil. There's thousands and thousands of thousands of people that are gonna try and meet them. Like... I don't know. If it's resale websites, yeah. There's no way that anyone could charge no one could reasonably charge $5,000 to have someone. You gotta be on some, like, next level high horse to think that you can charge even $1,000 for someone to meet you. Like, I don't know. Ridiculous. Trying to meet Ariana, but it's not looking good, kids. Do you know how much it would cost? I don't know anything about concerts. How, like, if I wanted to buy a meet and greet ticket for, like, a Taylor Swift or concert or something, how much would that cost? Does anyone know? Who would you pay $1,000 to meet? That's a good question. Would you pay $1,000 to meet anybody? Assuming you have $1,000, which most people don't have $1,000 to pay to meet somebody. But, like, would you pay $1,000 to meet anybody? To meet Einstein? You'd pay $1,000 to meet Shawn Mendes, Beyonce? I think, honestly, Beyonce might be the one. The thing is, like, certain people could, like, charge that, though. Like, some people, like Beyonce and Taylor Swift, like, they could pull that off. Like, you... I know you guys might not like Taylor Swift, but, like, you gotta admit she's mega famous. But... Jenna Marbles. I don't know. I don't know if I really care about meeting celebrities that much. Like, I'd probably be willing to pay $1,000 for, like, a really good seat at, like a really good theater ticket, maybe. You know, like, to see a show. I don't know if I'd pay the money to, like, just to meet somebody. Like, I don't know if I care that much about meeting them. Because, like, in my mind, I don't know, like, when you meet them as a human, it's really cool, but also sometimes it can be disappointing. And, like, it's kind of fun to have that, like, figure in your mind of this, like, super cool human.
Happy 18 months. I don't know. I love you, Kentucky.
Andrea, thank you so much for the 18 month resub. Thank you. I don't know why I called you Andrea. Either way, thank you for the 18 months. But, like, meeting your heroes is kind of scary. And it's such a weird situation with meet and greets, too, because you're paying all this money to meet them. And you get, like, a few seconds and a picture, right? And, like, that's... I don't know. I'm sorry, Andy. But, yeah, weird stuff. Because, like, in the obviously, I've done meet and greets in the past, but not, like, a meet and greet sort of... Actually, I had a meet and greet line at TwitchCon. Okay, so usually when I do a meet and greet, obviously, I am very small, physically and channel-wise. I'm a small human, and I've got a small audience, right? And so when I've done meetups in the past, at, like, VidCon in the past, usually I'll be like, hey guys, I'm hanging out near, like, the blow-up tent thingies. Come meet me over here. I'll be there for, like, an hour. And then people show up, and I take pictures of them, like, as they get there. And then people just kind of hang around and talk, and there's, like, maybe, like, 10, 15 people there. And we're all just, like, hanging around talking. And it's not like a... picture leave kind of line situation. It's like we're just talking at TwitchCon, not, well, and VidCon and whatever. because it's not like there's people that I'm trying to rush through so everyone gets a picture, because there aren't that many of them. And at TwitchCon, the same thing kind of happened, but I had an actual, like, official meet and greet line time slot at TwitchCon in the US last year. And so I was taking pictures with people and then leaving, but there weren't, like, enough to have it be, like, a quick, like, okay, you're gone now. Picture gone, right? Like, we had, like, a little bit of time to chat with each person, which is different than you would experience with, like, a very, very, very famous celebrity. Oh, I'm so sorry, Sleeping Bakery. I'm so sorry. And I remember the people I meet, too. That's different, because, like, if I've met you in person, I recognize you. Like, at VidCon, I'm not going this year, which kind of sucks, but, like, the past 2 years, a lot of the same people were there, and so, like, it was, like, seeing them again. Like, you know, it was like, oh, hey, guys, it's good to see you. How's your year been? You know, your hair looks great. Like, so that was kind of cool. That doesn't happen when people get bigger, obviously. Maybe it does, but I don't know. The more people you meet, the, like, less likely it is to recognize them. But wouldn't pay $1,000 even for Brandon Urie. Yeah, I don't think I'd pay $1,000 to meet anybody, to be honest. Well, I know VidCon, I'm not going to be in the country. I'm going to be in Italy with my mother and my family. My mom's been planning this trip for, like, years, and we're finally doing it this summer. And they changed VidCon to be in July instead of June this year, which, you know, you plan things expecting it to be in June, and then they put it in July, and it's like, well, that's not going to happen now, is it then? So I'll be in Italy. Sorry about VidCon, though. Like, that sucks. I'm going to miss VidCon, but, like, it's Italy, so. Crow, thank you for the bits. So when should we expect the Lil Simsy US tour? You can sit on a stage and play The Sims while we all quietly watch. Oh my god, I just... Can you imagine? Simsy live, and it's just me playing The Sims. And I hum. I do a humming. And I have a harmonica performance. I have a harmonica performance. I go on a harmonica tour, and I'm just like... and then it's over. I sing a song for every person in the audience, but it's just me going like this, and then yelling their name. For each person there. Oh my god. Can you imagine? That's what I want. That's my life goal, I think, is to go on a harmonica tour. You pay $1,000 for that? I'm charging $1,000 for admission to my harmonica tour. I can't even charge $1 for that, to be honest. Lancey, thank you for the bits. Hello, I love Italy. I've been 3 times in the past 2.5 years, so if you need any advice about places to go, let me know. But for real, Rick Steves' guidebooks are a godsend. My mom has been reading them. Don't worry. My mom has been planning this forever. She's really excited about this. If you want your name first, it's $2,000. Yeah, if you want, so, like, okay, the way it works for the harmonica tour, right? Listen, so I'm gonna sing a song for everyone in the audience, right? But it's like a bidding system, so the highest payer gets their name first, like, for their song, and then it goes down to the lowest, but it's minimum $1,000. But yeah, like, I'm, like, screeching your name. I'm not actually saying it. I screech your name. But, like, the earlier on you are, the more likely you're going to get your name actually said. Because, like, I mean, if you're first, I'm going to say your name. But, like, by the time I get to number 50 and I've been sitting here going and screeching names forever, like, you're not going to get your full name said. Perfect. When do tickets go on sale? All right, guys. So if you're looking for tickets, I'll put a link in the chat. Can you imagine? You have a kidney to offer? I'm also accepting kidney. Kidneys? Wait. Your kid has 2 knees? Oh, that's good. I can have both. Great. Will you accept a liver's help? I'm so scared. You'll be waiting for tour dates? I'll announce them soon. I'm going to every city in the entire world. my kidneys? Oh my god, whose kidneys you're gonna steal? Veggie Rug, what do you mean? I'm scared. But yeah, no, as long as they're kidneys, yeah, they're fine. Yeah. Don't come to Kentucky, though, it's gross here. Okay, I'm going everywhere but Kentucky. Simmers are wild. Okay. Never gonna build anything. Wow, Ghosty!
Already it feels like I only started subbing yesterday.
Hey, Ghosty, thank you so much for the 8-month resub. Thank you. Come to Minnesota and no, not in the winter. No. Listen, I'm from Florida. I'm weak. Careful. Kidneys for Kayla. And I don't even need them. I'm just collecting them. It's like a power trip, you know? When I go to Brighton. Oh my god, I want to go to Brighton so bad. Not kidding. I've been wanting to go for a long time, Simmy. Maybe someday. I would very much like to do that. If the gallery is still up, because down for maintenance. I mean, that's fine. I don't need the gallery to be open right now. Yeah, that doesn't matter. I don't need the gallery to build. I don't need the gallery. Listen, team, you can mention any city ever, and I'll be like, yeah, I'd love to go there. Doesn't mean that it's possible. Come to Brazil. Not to be that kid, but please, Brazil. I didn't even see your message until after I said it. Come to Brazil. Go to Florida? Maybe. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, Liam, when you said Preston, I was picturing, like, a person named Preston, and I was like, nah, I don't know where he is. Never met him. Don't know where he is. But sure, I assume you mean a place, though, which is awkward. Ever tried Orlando, Florida? You know, I actually have, yeah. Not liking it that much. My mods and I go on a world tour. Hashtag find Preston. Where do you guys think Preston is? Don't make the trip to Scotland? What's wrong with Scotland, Jen? You know what, Preston? He's kind of mean. Never mind. Forget about Preston. We don't like that guy. I know a Preston. No, he's nice. Preston's fine. Maybe yours isn't, but... You know what I mean? Where's Preston? What is Preston? Okay, let's find it out. Because now I feel like someone just said, oh god, no, don't go to Preston. There's a Preston law firm in Orlando. What's wrong with Preston in England? I'm scared. It seems fine. I don't know. Seems sketch. Okay, be nice. I mean, nice place. Stream Cities again soon? Maddie, I'd love to stream Cities again. Oh, no. We need to find Preston. His kidneys are valuable. Oh my god. Okay. Well. Preston for president. Preston 2020. What are we building? I don't know yet. I have honestly no idea what I want to build. You know? Build Preston's house? Where does Preston live? Wait, hold on. Like, listen, I don't know about the kind of houses in Preston, England. What about like a traditional English sort of house, right? We built one of those in honor of Preston. Thoughts on that? This isn't what I was looking for. I mean, honestly, I'm getting like this kind of vibe. It's not gonna be as like mossy in The Sims, but. Looks like Windenburg, mm-hmm. Is that where I stay? No. Someone was talking about Preston because they live there, and then someone else mentioned it, and they're like, don't go there. And then we were like, well, what's Preston? Where's Preston? Who's Preston? And then now we're building an English house. This is the kind of thing, like, when I think of, like, houses in England, I think this. Hi, like, this is the vibe. Sort of.
I'm too scared to ever talk, but I just want you to know that you're an amazing person and so wholesome, and I love your content.
Kelly, thank you for the 6-month resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate you very much, friend. I kind of like this one, too. This could be actually really pretty. Anyway, Kelly, thank you for the 6-month resub. You're very, very kind. But this is like beautiful cottage kind of house. Oh, they're all beautiful cottages. I love it. Hey, Emily.
Thanks for being great for 8 months. I can't account for your greatness before then since I wasn't subscribed, but I'm sure you were fine.
Oh, I was, yeah, I was like fine then. I wasn't great. Listen, I know that like the average house in England is not like this, by the way. it doesn't mean anything. Just, it's just a nice house, okay? It doesn't have to be a very fancy house. Let's get ourselves another one of these searches so that we could. This is the kind of thing that is more standard, I think. Some like semi. Okay, this look. Do you know what this is? Hey, do you know what that is? Wait, oh my god, hang on, we're gonna, Mads the Musical, thank you for the Prime sub. You, hold on. Wait. Amazing! How do I recognize that? Because I've seen it a million times. It's in my Simsy save and stuff. No way! That's so funny. Do you think that the what are the chances of that? They literally built. The thing is, I've always thought, and I'm not kidding, I've always thought this was like one of the nicest EA houses they've ever built. I've always been like, yeah, it's kind of like one of their best works. Like, I don't know how they pulled that off. It's not even in the game. It's just in your library. Like, I was always really impressed by this house. Like, it's kind of pretty on the outside. It could be better, but like, it's kind of pretty. This is literally this house. They copied it. That's so funny. Oh my God. I feel like I need to tweet this somehow. Like, this is. I mean, listen, I do this too, but this is really funny to me. No, the thing is, this is beyond inspiration. This is literally the same house. Like, no, you don't take inspiration from things that you copy. Like, look at the window placement. I mean, they don't have this dormer here. But like the rest of it, it's literally the same house. Like, even like down to the shape of the door. And all the window placement? I mean, listen, I'm not judging. I do it too. But that's really cool. Also, the fact that I recognize this is really funny to me. Like, how did I recognize this? Like, that's how you know you play The Sims too much. When you see this, you're like, that house in The Sims 4 library. I mean, I never tweeted out my stream, but like, that's so funny. Should I just tweet, like this? the Spot the Difference games. Tweet it from Preston. Oh my god. Was just browsing reference pictures of houses and stumbled upon this familiar gem. Nikki, thank you for the 18-month resub. Thank you. Wait, should I put like maybe the screenshot showing that it's by Maxis? Like that? No, I don't need to. I don't even need to tweet this. But like, would you recognize it? Like, if, for those of you guys that haven't seen it in your library, would you recognize this? Can I copy your homework? Yeah, just change it up a little. You did recognize it? Do it. You would not. I think I might make sure I'll put it like this so that people know what it is. Oh no, hello? Where's my Twitter? It's not even a big deal. I just think it's kind of funny. Paste the photo. Thank you. I don't want to like act like I'm trying to expose them, because I don't really care. I just think it's kind of funny. What's going on in the background of that tweet? This is Liza Koshy. I don't know what she's up to. I'm not gonna put a ha ha. I think this is so funny. I feel like I might need to explain this more. Hey, what the heck? Thank you for 7-month resub. I'm not gonna put a T emoji or tag the Sims. They follow me, they'll see. I'm just kidding. Put an LOL X at the end. No. This makes it seem really petty, and it's not supposed to be petty. I'm not putting that. I'm tweeting this, I think. I'm gonna post it. I'm really nervous. I don't know why. Because I'm not trying to expose them. I don't even care. We all do this. Maybe just go with Spot the Difference. The number of times I've tweeted these Spot the Difference games. Spot the Difference is more aggressive, I think. Doesn't like saying Spot the Difference seem like I'm trying to expose them? I'm not even trying to expose them. No, they didn't draw the house from The Sims. This is like a, where did it go? It's on, that's not the right tab. It's on this tab. It's an old English cottage house plan. It says it was published January 4th, 2017, but I'm not certain that someone designed this house based on The Sims house. You think the homework one is more exposy? Really? What? I don't know. Okay, I'm not trying to expose anybody. I don't want to expose. Show where the first pick came from. It's not even that deep. I'm just gonna tweet this. Oh my gosh. I'm scared. Also, bungalow. Hang on. How come they get to call this a Tudor bungalow, and then I call a house that isn't a bungalow, and I get attacked? Wait a minute. Oh my god. Did I add the stream? No. I didn't want to ruin the tweet with the Twitch link. I don't want to like post a follow-up tweet either, because I feel like doing that, it's too much. What even is a bungalow? I'll show you what a bungalow is. Hey, Messi! Thank you for the 18-month resub.
Who do you think gave you the teeth?
I'm scared. Anyway, bungalows are like this kind of house. They're like one-story houses. This kind of vibe. Not that. Bungalows. Not a bungalow. But... Oh, man. I could have made this meme. Jason, dang it. We were playing LOLX in her reply. You guys all reply LOLX. That's funny. I really like that. A new Sims 3 video coming today? Not today, I'm gonna post it tomorrow, Mama. Are the floor plans the same? I don't know if I can find the floor plans on this link. Maybe if I reverse image search this one, we can see if we can find. No. Get out of my way. I don't understand. Back to post. Ah. Wait, no, I don't. Is this that? No. Okay, I don't even care. It's fine. Those kind of things don't really have floor plans, though. Anyway, I hope I don't get accused of trying to start drama. I was just making a meme. I just wanted a meme. I just wanted to be funny. And I'm causing problems. I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it. Help. Okay. I'm an exposed channel now. Yep. Yep. I can't believe we stumbled upon that. I also can't believe that I saw that picture and I was like, you know what this reminds me of? Because, like, how do you see this and think Sims House? I think that's funny. I'm hilarious. Thanks for listening. I'm really upset about Brooke and Messi at the same time. Okay, I'm getting distracted. I kind of think we were looking at this house and maybe considering trying to build this one. Shall we? Okay, back to Preston. Preston still needs a house. I like the idea of it having like a wall kind of thing in front of it. I might do something like that. I think that's my vibe. Okay, that's the vibe. Vibe accomplished. I'm gonna save this picture in my... in my spot, so I know what I'm looking for. Okay, let's build, folks. Who's ready? Who the heck is Preston? We don't know who Preston is, Maggie. Yeah. Oh yeah, I'm not keeping the garages, by the way. I don't want to have garages in this house. That doesn't work in The Sims.
Hi, Simsy. I'm super excited because I'm moving in with my boyfriend next month and I'm excited to put my Sims decor skills to good use. Happy 10-month, you woo.
Hey, Dead Out Slide, thank you for the 10-month resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's gonna be awesome. Also, I'm not gonna make Preston in cast because Preston is an enigma, okay? We don't know who Preston is. He can never be created. You can't find out who Preston is because we aren't even sure Preston exists, okay? Who is Preston? Preston is a vibe. Preston is a figment of our imagination. Preston's also a real human. Preston is the air we breathe, the water we drink, and the food we eat. The body and blood of Preston. Oh my god. You never get the joke? Meme Queen, there's no joke to get. None of us get the joke. Preston is LOLX. It's Preston Jesus or something, yeah. Preston is a perspective, he's an idea, he's a kidney. Preston is the feeling you get when you find money in your jeans. Who is nobody but everyone at the same time? Preston. Oh my god. Preston is a way of life. Yes, okay. We're never gonna let this go, are we? Preston is the many-faced god. Preston is your mom. Okay. Any Preston watching the stream is shook. Oh, imagine being named Preston. Huh. Preston is the powerhouse of the cell. Oh my god. You'd pay $1,000 to be Preston. That was a good one. I'm really pleased with this. I'm really happy right now. Okay. Preston lives in everyone. We are all Preston. He adds to the strange. Okay, oh my god. I want to build in Windenburg, but all the lots are too small. And I hate this lot. It's fine, I'll build it backwards or something. Again. Help, I don't understand. Listen, none of us understand. If you guys don't get the Preston joke, don't worry. There isn't a Preston joke. That's the joke. Merely a goose, thank you for the 10-month resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I think the fun of jokes like Preston is everyone pretending to understand the joke, even though no one understands the joke. You know? Preston is the Preston joke, that's the thing. Annie, thank you for the bits. I don't really understand Twitch or bits, I only come here to watch your streams. Annie, thank you so much. Preston's when you gotta go to work. Okay, I'm gonna bulldoze this lot. Goodbye, we had fun. Alright, I'm also going to build this house backwards again because the lighting on this lot sucks. So I'm gonna build it backwards so that I can have better lighting. I hope that's okay with you. I realize it looks kind of dumb, but it's all about the lighting, okay? You gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, Giggle Girl, thank you so much for the Prime sub. 2 months in a row. You have a cousin named Preston? Preston is Preston Plays. Oh my god. Okay, we are supposed to have an idea of what Preston looks like, but if Preston looked like anybody, he looks like Preston Plays.
Bleed purple, Jay, thank you for the bit. Bonus 30, not gonna lie. When you said my full first name while we were on Twitter made me immediately think I was in trouble with my mom with how
forceful you said it.
Anyways, team, I will be starting a Sims 4 challenge where we try to use cast to create what we imagine Preston to look like. Good luck, Preston.
We are all Preston. Your Preston is just your Sim self. Jay, thank you for the bits. Also, the thing is, I read Jason because it was the Twitter name on there, and then I read the username and I was like, oh, it's Jay. But like, I just saw Jason at first and I was like, Jason, but it was you. I didn't know your name was Jason. It was a whole ride. It was really an emotional experience for me. we're closer now. My Stolen Melody, thank you for the bits. Preston is that warm feeling you get when you build with good lighting. Christian, thank you for the bits. My mom and dog love you now. Also, me. Lol. X. I like saying lol. Lol. X. Okay. I'm getting distracted. We're never gonna build a house in The Sims. Preston's trying to ruin everything. Okay. The tube was loud. I haven't watched or thought about Preston Plays in a long time. My sister used to watch his videos a lot back in the day. I could be wrong about this, but I'm pretty sure Preston Plays used to model for his own merch company, and I thought that was really good. Like, I thought it was really funny. Like, in a good way. I was like, wow. He did that. Because, like, sometimes, like, I don't know. It's just hard to explain, but I really respected that. You know? Shout out Preston Plays.
Wow,
Sammy!
We like BFFs now. I hope your day is going well.
Thank you for the 13-month resub. Okay. I'm getting distracted. Is my chat in follower only mode? I'm sorry, I didn't see Laura's message until just now. Ugh, my chat's been on follower only mode for how long? When did we do that? That was because of a... Oh, that could have been there for a long time. That was from the 12-hour stream, I think. Yeah, when the bots came during the 12-hour stream. It's been there that whole time. Oh, that's not good. It was 0-minute follower only mode, but still follower only mode. I hate streams that are follower only mode. That's like an immediate turn off. Like makes me like want to leave the chat when that happens. Oh, I'm sorry. That's bad. I feel icky about that. I didn't know it was there. But during my 12-hour stream, we had a bunch of bots come in and start spamming the chat, so we put it on follower only to stop the bots. What's follower only mode? It means you can't type in the chat unless you follow the stream. And I could put it on, like, you have to follow for 10 minutes, 30 minutes, whatever. But mine was on, like, just as soon as you start following, you could type in the chat, but you had to follow to type in the chat, because that way the bots couldn't type, because the bots weren't going to follow my stream. So we were stopping the bots from typing, because they couldn't type. I don't usually like follower only mode, because I think it's a really big deterrent for viewers. It definitely stops trolls from typing in your chat, but I think that it also stops as many, I think it stops more regular people from typing in your chat as it stops trolls. Like, I think it's, like, trolls are pretty frequent on Twitch and stuff, but, like, I think that follower only mode deters just as many trolls as it does regular viewers, and that's not a good thing. Like, if you go to a stream, you want to talk there and, like, meet the community and, like, get to know it a little bit before you follow them most of the time, and if you can't talk until you follow them, I feel like it makes me not want to stay at the stream, you know? It must work for other people and stuff, because people do it, but, like, I would never put my chat on follower-only mode. Following is free, but, like, I don't want to have to follow you to type in your stream. Especially when it has, like, a follower, like, sometimes you have to follow them for 15 minutes before you can type, so you have to be there following for, like, be there following for 15 minutes before you can even type in their chat, and that's, like, I don't know. It just deters people from staying there. But yeah. Sammy, thank you for the bit. It's actually almost my birthday, just saying, like, for real, for reals. Sammy, how long? I feel like, because, like, maybe you lurk for a little bit and then follow and then talk the next, or maybe you, like, lurk for a little bit, type a few times, like, ask some questions, meet the streamer, meet their chat, and then follow. Like, I always go to a stream for a little bit before I start following, and it sucks not being able to type in the chat until you follow. And I get that it makes it so trolls don't come to your stream and start typing because they have to follow you first, so it's not, like, trolls won't come, but I feel like it also turns away regular people that just want to watch your stream, you know? So I'm pretty, not into follower-only mode. I think it's necessary for people like Ninja and stuff like that. Like, Ninja can use sub mode, because otherwise his chat would be garbage, because he has thousands of viewers. Like, that makes sense, but, like, for a person like me to use sub mode, sub-only mode, so you'd be, like, paying subscribers to only type in the chat, I think that's icky. I don't know. It's good in waves, though. Not good total. Like, if I was having, like, a bad troll day, I might put follower-only mode on, like I did in the stream a couple weeks ago, but, yeah. And I think that sometimes it's fun, like, sometimes people will do things where, like, maybe, say I was, like, having my subs suggest names for my baby in The Sims, and I put on sub-only mode, so, like, everyone can type in the chat, but then for, like, the minute that I'm taking suggestions for names, only subs can suggest them, so I have sub-only mode for, like, a minute, but I wouldn't have my entire stream in sub mode, you know, because then, like, you can still hang out and chat, but, like, you just can't suggest a name when I'm taking them. And I think that's fair. It's like a perk for the subs. Doesn't really affect a non-sub, you know? But I wouldn't use it for everyone. Preston only mode. Oh my god. Can you imagine? I allow only people named Preston to type in my stream. Also, Sims Nerd, if you're looking to find out how long you've been following, you can click on your name in chat. Like, just click on it. You've been following since November 27, 2018. All you gotta do is click on your account, or on your name, and then you'll see it. Prestons don't interact. Prestons are everything and all things. Yep. Yep. Hang on, let me, quickly reply to someone who just replied to my tweet asking about where the illustration is from. I just found this while I was searching for reference pictures for a build and recognized it immediately. Nice. I'm so funny. Again, I don't really care. You guys, if you saw my tweet, I don't really care about the fact that it's copied, but like, it's funny. Very, very funny. Okay. Shall we build? What is Preston? What did I miss? Preston is everything and all things. Trust me, if you missed the meme, you didn't miss the meme. The meme is that no one knows what the meme is. The joke is pretending to know what Preston means when you don't actually know what it means. Zoe, I had a YouTube channel first and then I started streaming. Hey, Hildegard, it's nice to meet you. Thanks for dropping by. You got 99% love with Preston? Wait. We got a love-hate relationship. Harrington, thank you for the 9-month resub. Thank you. Yeah, I didn't tweet my stream out, but I don't care, Jay. We'll be okay. Sometimes maybe I don't want to tell Twitter. You know what? I don't need them. I'll be here by myself. I'm gonna start building, I think. I'm ready. What are we building today? I'm gonna build, I'm building it backwards, by the way, because the lighting on this lot is really bad, so I'm building it backwards so I can get better lighting. But I'm gonna build a sort of cottage type thing, like a traditional, maybe English cottage. Traditional is kind of a strong word, but that's the vibe we're going for here. Okay, I think I'm gonna make the walls shorter. This bit was supposed to have, there's like bump outs in the actual house where there's windows, but there's a garage there. We're not gonna put a garage, obviously, because garages don't exist in The Sims 4 because we don't have cars. So it would be dumb to put a garage because they don't exist in The Sims 4 because we don't have cars. Okay, folks, I'm gonna do some super weird things with the roof right now. You're gonna have to bear with me. I realize it looks really dumb. It's gonna look really good when I'm done. I understand that there is currently nothing here. So it's potentially not that exciting. All right, I don't know what to do with the back yet, so I'll just do the roof for now, and then we'll figure out the back in a second. But I know that I need to... yes. Perfect. Okay. Oh. That's not what I wanted. I want this to be... Oh, it's too far out, I guess, is the problem. Should you get Seasons or Get Famous? Oh my god, absolutely you should get Seasons over Get Famous. Like, without a doubt, no question even in that you need to get Seasons over Get Famous. That's taller than I want it to be, and I'm disappointed about it. Maybe if this were, like, farther over. Oh, I guess that's the solution to this problem, isn't it?
Was lilled and siestan, but I felt anxious in other
streams. Hey, Quinn.
Other than people like Kiwi. So I changed it, but the child's name is Duck Kayla.
Okay, seriously? Quinn, thank you so much for the resub. Trust me, I feel you with the being nervous in other streams. You're absolutely fine. Thank you so much for the 9-month resub. It's good to see you. What's the reference pick? It's just like an old English cottage. I'm not gonna put it on screen because it's got garages. I don't want people to get excited about that, because if I don't put the garages, they're gonna be like, but there's a garage, and I don't want to do that. I'm not gonna put the garages there. I'm not exactly copying the house either. I'm just kind of using it as a vibe, if you will. So, no. I need this for a spacing sort of reference, because I want to know. I'm gonna put this here. And I want to use it for sizing references. Okay. Better. Super good. Super, super good. And then the real house has this sort of thing at the top here that goes across. The real house being, again, the reference picture that I'm looking at that you can't see. Okay, why is that happening? Oh, is this, does this, wait, does it need to go one farther back? What's going on here? Why? It should be even. Why aren't you even? I'm frustrated. Okay. We try again with this instead. Okay, that'll be fine. Pointy. All right, look at that though. Can I? Disappointing to say the least. It's gonna have to be like that. But that means I can't get the, this is so frustrating because I don't want it to be like that. I have got some things to work with. William, thank you for the bits. Killer's a robot dog in a British film called Wallace and Gromit and the dog's called Preston. You know, I know about Wallace and Gromit. I didn't realize their dog was called Preston. That's interesting to me. Thank you so much for sharing. Okay. I'm trying to do something very specific here, but I'm not certain what the best way to go about it is. Because I kind of want to, like, I just want an overhang on that side. It's not going to work, is it? Like, I'm just not going to get this to work in any way, shape, or form that is what I want. So, with an open at one end but closed at the other. I don't understand what you mean. Put a tree, hide it. I mean, realistically, like, we could just make it so that it's not, like, this is fine. It doesn't need to have the overhang at all. I just wished it would, but again, like, if I, if when I put the roof trim on it, like, this part, it'll hide it better. We'll get, like, a, maybe even, like, a wider one or something. Like, it'll be fine. You won't even know. Put a chimney. That's not a bad concept either. The chimney in this house, for real, is more, like, over here. Which is kind of what I imagined I would put it. Or maybe even like, oh, but I guess that's not a bad spot for the chimney, huh? I have to make it wider then. Or maybe even skinnier. Let's make it skinnier. We're not gonna use that upstairs anyway. It doesn't matter. Who cares about the upstairs? I'm not gonna use it. Okay, that'll be good with the chimney. I think it actually might look a little bit stupid, but who knows? Ah, no. I want to leave it the way it is. Although, I'll keep it smaller, because it's better to make the house smaller than bigger. The house is too big right now, anyway. I might put the chimney back here, though. Like, I like, because this is a good spot for it, I think. I think this could be kind of cool to have the chimney, like, up here. Nah. Like that, or something. We'll put, like, an actual chimney so there's, like, smoke stuff coming out it. Patricia, thank you for the 8-month resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. The main house, the real one I'm looking at, has a bit like that on the roof. But I don't know if I like that all that much. Oh, I'll make it work. I'll make it work. Don't even worry about it. I think I want to copy this sort of roofing on this bit, though, as well. Which I wasn't planning on doing, but I think I'm gonna do now. It might look dumb with the chimney back there still, but that's okay. Charlie Girl, thank you for the 5-month resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I kind of like how that looks. Like, I think that's kind of cool. It's definitely an interesting piece. Right next to the kitchen? Yeah. So we can try and put, like, chimneys in around the kitchen area or something. Okay, you need to go all the way through here. You need to disappear. Okay, I might make this part smaller too. Because right now it's really not good. But it's gonna look good. I promise it'll look really cool. I swear. And again, Trolley, thank you for the 5-month resub. Make the square roof taller, maybe. In the real house, it is a bit taller, but I'm not certain that I want it to look like that. Can make it a little bit less square. Oh, I like that better. Okay, that's fine. I can get behind that. Okay. 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 Star, thank you for the tier one sub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Make it a round glass roof. Simple. We'll just put more glass roofs on the build, I think. The key to everything, the key to success is always a glass roof. I don't know if you guys heard that ever, but the key to success, again, I'll say it again, I'll tell you a million times. The best way to succeed in life with anything is to put a glass roof. Actually, I might do it like that. I don't know if I like it or not. Oh, I know we're going a little bit wild and crazy here, but I do like the idea of something like this. It looks like a face in a good way. It does look like a face, doesn't it? Dang it! Okay, I might keep it though. The front door is gonna be over here. So I need to figure out a better solution for the front door situation. It is gonna be kind of simple looking. And the house, I want it to have like a bit like that. And that's where the front door will go. And then I was sort of imagining that we would get another... Hello? Where did that dormer just go? Another dormer above it. Well, maybe we'll do like one... How about on this side we do one tile wide dormers? Small. Maybe too much, to be honest. I don't think I like this. I think I hate this area, actually. I think it needs to be a little bit less symmetrical. Does that make sense? Like, we can still have that sort of, like, honestly, we could put that kind of rounded thing, like, over here. I think that'll look really good. Also, we could even make it go farther out. Okay, so here's the thing. I learned during my build challenge how to do this and make it look good. Because I always noticed this, and I was like, well, it's, like, kind of pointy there, and it looks kind of dumb. So, for example, if it were, like, this is actually a good size because it's halfway. But, like, say it was, like, this big, right? And it looks like that, and it's kind of pointing out. Alexis, thank you for the Prime sub. You can take one of these roofs, right? And you can put it in there. Boom. Magic. Problem solved. Isn't that cool? So you could, like, have it... Oh, this doesn't fit this roof, obviously, but, like... And so it could be out as, like, wide as you wanted it to. Magic! Yeah! I never even considered that before, and I felt so dumb for not thinking of it, because I always, like, had that problem and wanted to fix it, but didn't know how. That's how. Oh, that's too big. It needs to be smaller. Sorry. Oopsies. Scoot farther back in. I don't want it to be too much. I didn't know that. Well, I just never tried. It wasn't like I didn't know. I just never tried. Thought it was common knowledge. All right. You guys are being rude. I think I'm decently good at roofing houses normally. I don't often use rounded roofs and stuff. No need to be mean about it. You guys are mean. Please help. Okay. The main house that I'm looking at, it's got kind of like, oh, you know what we could do? Like this. I want it to look a little bit more, I guess you'll see what I'm talking about. I'm gonna put this here. Was I gonna put a, certainly not gonna put a 4 wide one there. You know what I could do? Figure out some kind of roofing to put here. Hey, Ethan, thanks for the 5 months.
By the way, happy 5 months.
Don't be mean to Kiosk. Thank you for the 5 month resub, Ethan. I appreciate you very much. Actually, I won't put that there. I might instead put this here. That's simple enough, and I think it looks good. And it makes sense, right? Hey, Rob, thank you for the prime sub. Thank you. I appreciate you very much. Tomorrow is senior recognition night. You're getting a scholarship. Alexis, that's awesome. And Lunar, thank you so much. You're very, very kind. Looks nice. Okay, I'm glad that you like it. This bit over here, I was just going to... I need to, like, copy this so I can get the same angle on this, but... I guess I could just build it myself. I don't need to copy it. I could even do the same roofing texture on it if I do it this way. We're gonna have a super huge attic on this build. How exciting. Okay, I don't want it to be this wide though. Put the grid on. Where am I? Okay. You can go there. I'm gonna make you a little bit smaller. You are currently too big. Oh, you're much too big. I'll make you, how big are you? Oh, three is the minimum big. If I make it smaller, it'll be like a weird bathroom sort of shape. But the house, you're gonna look at it mostly from like this angle anyway. So it's fine. Yep, okay. this part. I was thinking, because I'm not let me put move objects on. BB.move objects on. I was sort of imagining that we'd get just like something fancy to hold it up instead of like a full-on column or something. Maybe we should put a column. Never mind, that's not gonna work. I'll figure it out. You just go, yep, that's my email now. Well, honestly, what's the problem? Macy, thank you for the bit. Thank you. Hi, Kayak, I finally made it to- Wait, no, I read them backwards. Why? Oh my god, they come in at once and then I read the first one, but it was second one. Star, thank you for the bits. Hi, Kayak, finally made it to a stream. I've been following you since before the noodle days and you're so awesome and I've come such a long way. Hey, Star, thank you so much for the bits. It's good to see you. And Macy, thank you for the bits. Recently made a sim named Regina Phalange. I love this sim. Must protect her with my life. But by the way, loving the stream and all the different kinds of builds you've been doing recently. Keep up the good work. Thank you so much, friend. That was really kind. Ow. Yeah, like a fake driveway or something. We'll make it look, because they have all the stuff out there. Okay, so as far as the coloring on the build goes, I was thinking we would do some sort of stone, right? Let me look at the, obviously we're going to use get to work stuff, but nope, get together. Dang it, I always say the wrong one. I was thinking like this sort of stone on like the majority of the house, okay? It's not actually going to be all of this, but I'm just going to paint much of the first floor with it. Potentially that part of the second floor. And then, I'm gonna use this, but I like it with the lighter color scheme. Does that make sense? Like, I think that's kind of pretty. Is my light fixed? Yeah, my dad finished fixing my light yesterday. No worries, guys. But yeah, we can make this work really well. It's gonna look really good. I like the light colors on it. I don't know if I like that, but I don't know if I want it to be white either. Maybe I'll do a gray. I might put it skinnier. How about this gray color? It'll match the stone, and I think that'll be a good thing. Right? Okay, let's pick the roof coloring too. I want to go for a gray color again, but I don't know. Most of the grays are just like blackish colors that we have. No. No. We do this one. No. Oh. Wait. There's gonna be a lot more paneling on this house. I kind of like this color. And we'll get some more paneling to kind of like branch out a little bit, but an accent color on the roof, like a darker color. This is darker than most of the house is gonna be though. Like much of the house is gonna be very light colors with the panel. I'm gonna put a lot more paneling on this. The front wall is too flat. Yeah, I'm gonna put, like I said, a lot more paneling on this. I'm also gonna put like maybe some windows that branch out a little bit. It's gonna be, this is gonna look a lot different once I finish with the color scheme and stuff. Cause I was gonna put like a, there's gonna be a column and a stair. I've got a vision. Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it, okay? Let's do it now. Get together, maybe? No! Why don't they... They didn't come with a railing. I forgot about that. Okay. We could just use a white one then. I hate it! No, it's ugly. I don't wanna... That's incredibly frustrating. Black? You think... I don't know about black. I like the idea of, like I said, like a gray color, but I don't know about a black. Why does it not match? Why do you not... Because I think the black is too much. I think white might be better. Stone railings? Maybe. I think their door might be inset a little bit in the build that I'm looking at. I wonder if that would look weird. I mean, obviously the roof is going to come out. I don't know if I'll actually do that or not. It's also only going to be a 2-wide door. It was going to be this door. So I don't know if I want it to be inset or not. Hi, Bailey. Thank you for the 12-month resub. 12 months, by the way. That's a long time. Thank you so much. Okay. Let's look at windows. I'm gonna look at the get-together ones. I have these windows that I get to use on this build. I think that's really good. I'm excited. That's the right color, though. And then I can put this window on this one. Obviously, I'll put like a flower box underneath it. Shelby, thank you for the bits. I'm probably gonna delete it, but I put a photo of Joseph and I in the Discord under selfies. Also, trigger warning. I'm so sorry, Shelby. Thank you for the bits. I'm sorry that happened. I love you a lot. Didn't know until you went in either. I'm sorry. You like the music you're dancing to it? It's good. This is the Sims 2 soundtrack. It's really good stuff. Would recommend 100%. okay, we'll put the same, obviously, down here. Fine now, had snacks. I'm glad. Laptop mouse just died. Oh, I'm sorry. Ooh, also forgot about this bit. Love the L shape. Yeah, I like the L shape too. It's gonna be really weird to do a floor plan for, but that's okay. Speaking of which, let's remove a lot of the walls that are not necessary. Okay. And there is an upstairs, but like I said, this isn't gonna work for anything. We just put storage up there. Hey, student crier, let's not question stuff like that. You never know. It could be a blood thing. Okay. I'm trying to decide which bits I want to put into paneling. I think... Possibly, that's the wrong color. Actually, with the white paneling and the yellow accent instead of the white with the yellow accent, I think I might like that better. It's not yellow, it's just like a light colored wood. Let's switch it. We'll switch it. I think I like that better. It has that lighter vibe we were going for, you know? It's really pretty. It's elegant. We can get a matching railing on these things. That's all that matters, is the matching railing. I'm trying to use a base game one. Which one did I use? This. I don't know if I'll keep that, but I will for now. Okay. Nice. Good stuff, Simsy. Okay. And then I think I'll put... I don't know what I want to do. I think I'm going to do... This is always the worst part, like trying to figure out when you're making like all this fancy paneling and stuff, trying to figure out where you want to put different bits of it and stuff like that. Like, it's always so confusing, but it's going to look so good, I promise. I know what I'm talking about. I'm a genius. Don't even worry about it. Hey, Nikki, thank you for the bits. Right now, I'm super sick, and watching this is making my day much better. Keep up the great work. I'm so sorry you're sick, Nikki, but thank you, thank you, thank you. Do you think I'll do open beams in this house? I don't know if I can pull it off in The Sims 4. It's a lot more difficult than you might imagine to do stuff like that. It doesn't really work in this game. I mean, obviously, I'd really like to, but I just don't know. I don't know how feasible that is. Get together. See, this is not good spacing for a window like this, but I could put one. You only two wide? No, that's ugly. I think that would be really cute to put up there. I just don't... If I switched them around so that the tiny bits were out. Raise it up too tight. No, we can leave it there. Is that not big enough? It might be better to have a bigger window there. Just because it's so small. One, two. Right? Thing with spandrels in my shell challenge. The issue with doing that, I know what you're thinking, Bailey, but like the issue with doing that is that I have to make the rooms would be like this if I was gonna do the spandrels for the open beams. And the beams wouldn't go away when you're playing in the house. So as far as like a gameplay standpoint, because all the, like every line is a different room, and then there's like these spandrels above it, like for doing it in the whole house is really not very realistic. Maybe in like some parts of the house, but definitely not the whole place, I don't think. It just isn't practical for the whole house. Can I do it in the attic? Yeah, probably. Yeah. We'll see. We'll figure it out. It'll be fine. All right, I'm going to put this window here. 20 this year, Alexandra. Do you have a source for this? Not that I don't believe you, I'm just wondering if we can see it too. That's, 20's a lot. Open up some part of the ceiling and put beams there. Not a bad idea. Stop getting rid of my filters. Terrible how it blocks a lot of things. Hey, Potato, thank you for the bits.
I've been really busy with work and playing Stardew, and I just wanted you to know that thanks to you help, I'm probably marrying Leah by the end of the autumn.
Nice!
Because I'm at about 6 hearts and I've been watching a ton of videos.
Thank you so much, Potato, for the bits. I appreciate you very much. How low are... These are actually, like, super low. I know they don't look that way, but they are. That's probably a better positioning for them. And I, you know what, I think we might need to put, I don't like these windows here. I think it needs to be something a little bit bigger that stands out more. But again, Potato, thank you so much for the bits. I like Leah a lot. She is a nice gal. You're so close. Your love is blossoming. Can I do a tiny build? Ooh, I haven't done a tiny build in a long time. That would be kind of fun, but I also, oh, that's true. That 20 content drop, that may, see, I was, like, doubting it's real because of how much it said it was, but, as Cyan Soul said, most of it is probably gonna be on console, so it's not like it's a new content drop altogether, it's just, a new content drop for a lot of the players. Not all of the players. So, like, they'll release, existing Sims 4 packs onto console, if that makes any sense at all. No, I want to use a fancier one. Hey, Miner's Girl, thank you for the 12-month resub. Oh my goodness. Yeah, cute balcony patio thing, exactly. That's the vibe. Cool. Oh, you know what I need to fix? The border on it. No, it's too dark. It's a yellow-toned thingy. Hey, Celion, thank you for the entertainment while I'm struggling, but, struggle busing with my back hurting. I appreciate you, human. Thank you so much. Sorry, that, sometimes, because I've showed you this before with my Streamlabs, it cuts off words in the middle of a sentence, like, in the middle of a word, so, like, to go to the next line. Sometimes I'll be reading things, and it cuts in the middle of a word, and I'm, like, looking at it, and I'm, like, whoa. What does that say? And then I have to, like, think about it. Because, again, it cuts it in the middle of the word. Why? Who thinks it's a good idea? Who thinks it's a good idea to cut in the middle of a word? Shelby, looking up Elliot cosplays because I think Joseph looks like him and it said Lit Una looks like Elliot. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Yeah, Lit Una does look like Elliot. I know. It's kind of wild, isn't it? I didn't watch the Maxis Monthly today. I was, really busy this morning, so I didn't get a chance to watch Maxis Monthly, so I am not the right person to ask about what happened in it today, unfortunately. I wish that I could offer you, more information about today's Maxis Monthly stream, but again, I was not there, so I do not know what took place. maybe I'll make it darker. I think it could be good to have a slightly darker... I don't like this window there. I want this to be a balcony, but I also don't like the two wide doors that we have. I guess I could put this door there. I mean, it does make sense. And we could put some, like, ivy stuff growing up. No content reveal? Yeah, because EA Play is coming up, so I assume that they're going to drop a trailer probably pretty soon for a new expansion, which they'll... allow people to get their hands on an EA Play, which is, that's kind of my timeline, I'm guessing, is they'll have content released after EA Play, information at EA Play and stuff like that. Like, I think that's all gonna revolve around EA Play this time around. When's EA Play? Early June, in like a month. What do I do at EA Play? I'm gonna get my hands on the pack and record content for you guys. End of May or early June, yep. But yeah, that's at EA Play. I get early access with the pack and I get to play it before it comes out and I can record some videos and stuff. And see all my Sims friends. But yeah, the point of EA Play for creators is to get their hands on the pack early so we can make content for you guys. Okay, I need to figure out the whole back of this house still. Which pack is it? They haven't announced it yet, so I don't know. I don't know what the pack is going to be. Given past events, I'm assuming that it's an expansion pack. Can't confirm that, but I can basically confirm that, because that's what they always do events for expansion packs. Eileen, thank you for the Prime sub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I have to hold on to it. There's an embargo lift date for any EA events, and also early access content. Sometimes I'll get, like, a pack early, like, a few days in advance, and then I can't post the content until, like, 4 days later or whatever the embargo is. But yeah. I don't know if there will be a Sims 5, but I do assume there will be a Sims 5, and I assume they're working on it right now. given the fact that the old lead producer, Grant, moved to other projects within EA, unnamed projects within Maxis, I am assuming, could be wrongfully assuming, but I don't think it's a wrong assumption to make. I think that Grant, who's been on The Sims forever, has been moved to The Sims 5. Which won't come out for a few years, if it's even in the works, but, that's what I think is happening, so. Grant's working on Preston, obviously, yep. They moved Grant to work on Preston, that's his current, job. I like Grant, too. I think he's great. I got to meet him last year at EA Play, and we talked to him for a long time, and I think he's really, really cool. I've said it before, but I think he's one of the most interesting people I've ever met in my entire life. Like, genuinely, I think he's one of the most, if not the most interesting people I've ever met. He's really smart, and he cares a lot about The Sims, and that's really cool, especially considering how much we care about The Sims. It's cool to know that someone who cares more than us is working on the game, you know? He's been working on The Sims forever. It's really cool. I don't know. I think he's a really, really cool person. Much of The Sims team is very, very cool. I don't know what I want to do about this. I think it needs to have something else. Possibly, like, what I did on this side of the house. Again, right here. Just so it kind of splits it up a little bit. Because I feel like that is just, like, one big empty wall. It looks kind of dumb. Okay. Would I still post Sims 4 content if there's a Sims 5? Yeah. For a little bit. I mean, I still post Sims 3 content right now, and The Sims 4 has been out for years. But obviously, like, there would come a time that I would sort of, like, stop posting Sims 4 content, and move to The Sims 5, which I think that just is how it be, you know? that's just the way that it works. But yeah, I would be excited for The Sims 5. I'm curious to see what they would do with it. I think that's a really fun concept to think about, you know, like what The Sims 5 would be like. But like, you would all move to The Sims 5 too, probably. That's just how it is. And everyone's gonna complain at first about how it's different from The Sims 4, and like, they missed this in The Sims 4, and The Sims 4 was so much better than The Sims 5, and then a few years down the line, they're gonna be like, oh wait, The Sims 5 is better than The Sims 4. Right. I overreacted. Interesting. That's how it always goes. It's kind of exciting, I don't know. Okay, guys, I'll say it again. Just because they're starting The Sims 5, we think, maybe, doesn't mean anything about The Sims 4. They have at least 3 years left. They've, like, confirmed 3 years left of The Sims 4 of content planned and stuff like that, at least. And it takes, like, 3-4 years to develop a game like The Sims 5. So it's gonna be a long time. You have nothing to worry about. I don't understand the idea of being like, no, not The Sims 5! The Sims 4 isn't done yet! Because you're forgetting the, like, timeline that it takes to make a game like that. But yeah, I don't know. Kind of wild, I guess. Okay, I think, you miss Sims 2 a lot? I never played The Sims 2. I am not on board that Sims 2 train, because I missed it. I do feel like I missed out a little bit, but I just have, like, I tried to play The Sims 2 once, and I just really had no interest in it, and I think it's because of the fact that I didn't play it when it was out, and so playing The Sims 2 now, from, like, a more modern perspective, with access to this, like, this game and The Sims, like, more recent ones and stuff like that, it just, The Sims 2 isn't good compared to The Sims 4. Like, as far, I mean, maybe the content in it was fun and nostalgic and stuff like that, but, like, The Sims 4 actually works. Whereas other Sims games don't run. So it's not as fun, I don't think, to play The Sims 3 and The Sims 2 and stuff, just because they don't work on your computer. But it is fun to play them because, like, it reminds you of your childhood and, like, the old Sims days and your first Sims games and stuff like that. But otherwise, I don't really think they're worth playing. Soundtrack slaps, though. Yeah, exactly. We'll have a greenhouse in this build? Maybe. I don't know. I have not considered the landscaping much, to be honest with you. Okay, I need to make that lower. Ew. It's ugly. Ew. There we go. You hold a grudge against The Sims 3 for a while as a result because that's the way you are? Yeah, like, everyone, when the new Sims game comes out, they're all, like, mad about it, and they hate the new Sims game, and they miss the old Sims game, and, like, that's just how it is, unfortunately. But it's gonna be like that with The Sims, like, with the new, whatever new Sims game comes out. People are gonna hold a grudge against it, and they're gonna miss the old Sims games, and I just think that's really funny. Okay, I want this roof to go where it needs to go. I'm so angry. I don't like this. I don't think I like this at all, to be honest. Everyone is so picky. Yeah, that's a good... I don't know if picky is maybe the right word, actually. I think that people just care a lot about The Sims, and they have really high expectations. And that's fair. Like, they've been playing the game for a long time. They paid a lot of money for the game, too. Like, people have put a lot of money into The Sims franchises, you know? So I think it's fair that people are picky, but sometimes they're mean. I don't mean it doesn't work anymore, Vanya. You can still play The Sims 2 and The Sims 1. I'm just saying they don't run on your computers very well. And some people physically cannot run The Sims 2. Like, The Sims 2, you have to, a lot of times on newer graphics cards, you need to, like, go into the settings and change... Like, I had to, like, mess with The Sims 2 settings and, like, go into the game files and change things for it to run on my computer. Like, I had to actually change the game files. Like, not, it wasn't that deep, but, like, you know, The Sims 2 doesn't work on newer graphics cards. And I don't think you can deny that. because, I mean, I tried to run it on this PC and it doesn't. So that's really frustrating about it. But, like, it, you know, it'd be like that. It's an old game. But, yeah, it's just a little frustrating. But again, it's an old game, so, like, you don't expect anything less than that. But it's just, I think, more fun to play The Sims 4 and stuff because they work. And they don't lag, and the game doesn't crash, and stuff like that. Looking good, Lil Simsy. Thank you so much. Scared about the graphics? Yeah, I think that's really interesting, too. I'm curious what they do with graphics, because a lot of people really hate The Sims 4 graphics and miss, like, the more realistic-looking stuff. And obviously, I don't miss the more realistic-looking stuff at all. And so I'm curious to see what they would do with that in The Sims 4. There's a lot of fun things that we can theorize about and, like, wonder what they'll do with. I think that's kind of the most exciting part about stuff like that. Sorry, I had to talk to Laura about something. It was really important. Thanks for listening. Okay. There is a ceiling. What? Yeah, I think realistic, like, The Sims 3, when you go into it now, like, I think that there are still a lot of things about The Sims 3 that are really pretty, and I do like The Sims 3. But, like, when you look at the graphics, sometimes it's like, it's hit or miss, isn't it? Because sometimes it's like, oh, The Sims 3 is so pretty. And then you look more closely and you're like, oh, The Sims 3. You know? Whereas The Sims 4 is, like, kind of cutesy, and I kind of like The Sims 4 graphics. I don't know. Yeah, and like the realistic graphics, like you said, they don't age well. Like it's gonna look really dumb in a few. This looks really dumb right now. It's gonna look really dumb in a few years when they're no longer like high quality realistic graphics. They're just. You kind of like them? I kind of like them too, but sometimes I see things and I think it's really ugly in The Sims 3. So. And all the Sims. Like, listen, all the Sims in The Sims 3 looked identical. Exactly the same. Miss the color wheel? The color wheel in The Sims. Like, listen. We all miss the color wheel, don't we? There's no way around that one either. I think I'll put. I'm gonna switch up the chimney situation over here, because I think that's better. I kind of like that. I need to do something else here, though. Maybe I'll do that same balcony situation that I did in the front. I don't know. I think it's a good way to make the back look more interesting. She says, hopefully. You wish we had matching swatches? Yeah. I have always wished we had better swatches in The Sims 4. It's really frustrating, but I do think that it's helped me be a little bit more creative with my builds. But I think there's a line, because I don't necessarily know that I need a color wheel back. Obviously, I wouldn't complain, but, like, I think I just wish that we had more ability to mix and match things. Like, how in The Sims 2, and in House Flipper and stuff, you can change the color of, like, the frame and the bed mattress separately, so I could change the comforter and the frame separately on a bed. I wish that we could do that. Like, and, or if I could change, like, the wood color on the counter and the countertop separately, like, buy a cabinet. I mean, it'd be the same thing, but, like, you select the color of the cabinet and the color of the countertop separately. Or, like, the color of the chair cushion and the color of the wood on the chair separately. So that, like, you can sort of mix and match a little bit more. Yeah, you could do it in The Sims 2 and 3. Like, it's more customizable. You can make things look better. I think that's a really happy medium there. So I'll still take your swatches, but, like, as long as I have more control over them to do what I want, I think I like that a lot. I posted a video the other day where I talked about, like, my issues with some things in The Sims 4, and it stems down to, like, the lack of control over things. Because, like I said, The Sims is a game where I want to be able to do whatever I want, you know? And I don't like it when the game interferes with that. So stuff like in City Living, the apartments, I can't remove the lot traits on some of them. And I don't like that. The game is at that point interfering with my gameplay. Like, I like that they exist in the beginning. I like that they can be there to guide me a certain way towards gameplay of a certain kind. But I want to change it if I want to, and I can't change it. You know? But so I miss that a lot. I miss that aspect of The Sims. Okay, also the build is done. At least the outside of the build is done. I think I'm gonna put some borders around the place, though. I don't know how that looks, but I think I'd like to put some borders along some of these bits, like columns there. Just on the edges of the brick. Maybe, no I won't, no I won't. It's fine. Simsy, you're being dramatic again, and you don't need to be. like, and the dead person plaque in the apartments, I can't remove the plaque. That's limiting my ability. I don't want that. Like, I like that you've put the plaque there, and let me cheat to get rid of it, you know? Like, if I turn on move objects, I should be able to, like, delete those items. Or if I, like, or even, like, ignore gameplay unlocks, like that cheat, I should be able to remove those items, you know? I think that'd be a lot better. Exactly, just call me teacup. That Spice District apartment, the one with the balcony in the Spice District, is the best apartment in the game. It's the perfect size, because they're all too big. It's the right size, there's a balcony, it's like such a cute apartment, but I can't get rid of the stupid bad lot trait, so it ends up having these awful, awful things happening, like all the rats coming in, because it's a needs TLC apartment. And I hate that. Like, I want to change it to be a better, like, more functional apartment that doesn't have to have rats everywhere, and I don't want to put a mod in my game to do that. So I like the concept of making it needs TLC. Like, I like the fact that it needs TLC. I'm not complaining about that. But, like, I just wish that I could change it if I wanted to. I don't know. You can't win. But. What did you say, Hope? Is there not a mod for that? No, yeah, you're fine. There is a mod for that. But, like, I don't want to use the mod in my gameplay. Because I don't really... I shouldn't have to, for one. And, like, I don't care that much. Like, I don't care enough to need that, you know? Yeah, and the apartments are all so big. That's a whole other issue. But, like, I want to play in apartments because I want them to be small. And the apartments in The Sims 4 are so big. which is fun sometimes. But, like, they're all really big. And that's not what I want. Oh, the blue is fun. Like, I don't want those giant apartments. And I wish you could change the hallways, too. That's a whole other issue. I like this. I think that's pretty. But yeah, starting households and apartments is really fun and, like, very realistic, and, like, I love doing that. I want more power. Yeah, the blue and concrete one. Yeah, the one in the Spice District, the apartment building to the right, with, like, the long skinny ones with the really tall wall height. Like, that hallway has bright blue walls and concrete floors. Ridiculous. Whose idea was that? Awful. Just awful. I don't know. And the walls are so tall. It's so bad. You just can't play in that apartment. It's unplayable. This is so sad. Does this look like it was growing up the wall a little bit? Or is that dumb? No, that could have grown up the wall. It grew up the wall. You're welcome. I'm gonna put some flowers in it. Yes. Now, should they be blue or white? Maybe I'll do blue so it stands out a little bit more. Yes. Okay. Good. I like it. I like it. Can I put it on the fence? Not very easily. I wish. It'll be off. Like, it won't look good, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Can you see? Like, it's just... I could... Don't... Okay. Hang on. Gonna try and auto place this wall. Let me, if I like do this and size it down, put it more on the fence there. That's kind of good. That makes sense for how it got up there. Yeah, these tiny apartments with huge walls. Exactly, Alexis. The wall height is the biggest issue in those apartments because the tall wall height in The Sims is so ugly. Like, you just can't get around that. The tall wall height is really bad. There's nothing good about it. It looks stupid in every build because we don't have, like, big enough things to... I don't know. It looks dumb. The tall wall height sucks, okay? I'm sorry. That's the way it is. It's so bad. The medium one is okay and works in a lot of situations. The tall one is just not good. And, like, all the apartments having those giant walls look so weird. I think, is that clipping inside of the house? Evil. Okay. I'll make you small. That's better. Yeah, the tallest wall height, like, listen, look at this. What kind of ridiculous mess is that? And the kitchens look so dumb in tall wall heights. And the thing is, like, if you had a tiny apartment, like, in real life, this is what a tiny apartment looks like. This is your New York City apartment. It's, like, tiny walls, a couple windows, and this really small, cramped, dark space. In The Sims, your tiny apartment, it looks like this. Here's my tiny apartment. And then look, this is your front door. here's my tiny apartment. And the front door's also, like, brown or something. Oh, that's not the right one. Look, there it is. Do you like it? And, oh, also the windows, by the way, they look like this. They're in, like, the worst places they could possibly be. That's your tiny apartment. Well, these aren't good enough. They're not big enough. They need to be, like, more ridiculous looking. They look like this. And so it's impossible to, like, make a floor plan or put curtains on them because they look like that. Yeah. Nova, thank you so much for the bits. Listen, and also the tiny door is the worst part. Like, your front door looks like that, and this. So your entryway is like, ooh, fancy entryway in my giant apartment with my tiny front door. It just looks so dumb. Oh no, hang on. All right, problem solved. We're back, folks. Sorry, I got a little bit aggressive there. I got really stressed. I was not happy with The Sims for that. Okay, I think I'm gonna put some more of this stuff on this corner here. Does that go inside? It doesn't. Awesome. Okay. Do I get famous? I like Get Famous. I wouldn't say it's like my first recommendation. Like if you don't have other packs, I'd probably get like Seasons or Cats and Dogs over Get Famous, but I do think Get Famous is worth it. It wouldn't be my first choice, you know? Love my tweet today. Thank you. I thought it was funny. We noticed on stream and we were like cry laughing about it a little bit. But yeah. I don't know. I got distracted looking at the replies to my tweet. Because it's not actually a big deal. They're acting like people think I'm exposing The Sims. I'm not trying to expose anybody. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to expose anyone. I just wanted to make a meme. I was just memeing, okay? I was just memeing. Just meme things, you know? Hang on. The more I think about that tweet, if you guys didn't see it, we noticed that there's a house in the Sims 4 library that is like a direct copy of a reference house, like that someone had put online, like a drawing of a house. And the more I think about it, like, I think it's one thing to use a reference picture, but it's another to copy the house. Like, for example, I used a reference picture for this house. Like, this house I didn't envision in my own head, right? But, like, this is the reference picture I was looking at. Right, which is, and then this is the real house. So it's similar, but it's definitely different. But like the house in the gallery is a Max's house. Like that they put in your library. Like this is what I was talking about. And this is like a direct copy, which is why it's like a little bit questionable to me. But like when I built it, I don't know, it's a reference, but it's not the same. You know? But I don't know, it's no big deal. It is fine, let us do floor plan now. It be like that sometimes. Okay, let's put this up here. This build screams romantic garden stuff. Okay. Alright, I'll just put lights there for now so I can figure out the floor plan. Can I make a window seat? Oh, there are definitely some spots that are good for window seats in this build. Don't even worry about it. Okay. I think, though, that I'm gonna turn, this into a bedroom. I believe, and I kind of want this to be turned into, actually, you know what I could do? Let's make this bigger. This is gonna be the dining room, I think. I'm gonna put a half bathroom here, maybe a shelf unit there. The entryway is gonna have like a beautiful big archway right into the dining room. It's gonna look so nice. Like you're gonna have like a beautiful, like, wow, look at that. architectural details and such. I'll put different lights in here too, but it will look like that for now. Entryway closet. I'd rather have a bathroom. It's gonna be a small house, so we're trying to think logically about this one here. I think the kitchen needs to go somewhere sort of that makes sense. This seems like more of a living space area to me over here, but it might have to be more bedroom stuff. Shelby, oh, also my friend Casey got into a TikTok compilation video. Heck yes. Impressive, honestly. I think this might be a living room instead of a... I was going to make it into just not a living room, but it's gonna be a living room instead, I think. I want it... Can I put, like... No. I just want it to be big and open. I want it to be pretty and open. I think this business of compilation videos is really dumb. Do you want to know why? It's stealing people's content. Use a door. It's not a small house, it has more than four rooms. Okay, fair play, but it's also kind of smallish. Okay. All right, this will be a bathroom of sorts for somebody. This is in a very inconvenient spot. That'll be a bedroom. That can be the master bedroom, maybe. This can be a child's bedroom. I could even go like this, make it a little bit bigger. Okay. I think I want to close this off as more of a hallway area. I realize it's not entirely a hallway, but I want to close it off some more. What button do you hold to delete the wall? If you hold control and then redraw the wall, you can delete it that way. Maybe I'll move that, actually. I need to figure out where I'm going to put... Because I want to close off the kitchen needs to be more closed off than it is right now. And I want the entryway to feel more like a enclosed sort of entryway. So I'm going to do this with the columns, what I've been doing here. And then what you do is I put a fence like this. Hi Scott. Hi house. It's only two bedrooms right now. It might be bigger, but it's also not, I don't know. The floor plan makes it hard to make it have more bedrooms than this. I realize that it seems a little bit small, but it's hard to make it more. Okay. I don't know if I can do more than this. And then I delete this bit, so it looks like a fancy entryway, you see? But really, it's a fake room. It's a fake room. See? Anyway, hi, Scott. You should, if you guys don't follow Scott on Twitch, you should give him a follow. He's a friend of mine, and he's great. No. Okay, sorry. I got distracted. I mean, to be fair, I could keep that as the half bathroom I wanted, and this could be a hallway. The hallway could, oh, never mind, I was gonna try and make it into a bedroom, but this might make more sense to, like, because what I'm trying to do here is make the floor plan feel more closed off, right? Because this is supposed to be an older house, and so the more closed off the floor plan is, I think the better. And so I kind of like, there's like a hallway that leads into where the bedrooms are. I could even make the kids' bedroom a little bit bigger that way. It makes for a really weird master bedroom, though. But it's a weird house. No, I don't like that. Put it back. Put a hall closet. I think the half bathroom is a good idea. I think the half bathroom is more important than a hall closet. I could do it like that. It could be a full bathroom that way. And we could put like a little desk nook or something. Hey, Scott!
Love you lots. Can't wait to see you next month.
Hey, thank you, friend. It's good to, thank you for the 87, nah. I was gonna say it's good to see you, and I just was like, wait. It will be good to see you, but it is good to see you here in the stream, Scott. Thank you for the resub. Can we have a secret room, Alyssa? Maybe. I don't know. I also don't know where to put the kitchen. Anyways, God, thank you so much for the resub. Okay, this is supposed to be the dining room, living room. The walls are so weird to put a kitchen in here. I don't know what I'm doing. Unless I close this off and put another... Oh, you know what this could be? We could have, like... this is such a big room, though. To be the... This could be the... Like, this should be the master because it's so big. But, like, we can make all the rooms smaller. We could have a few kids' bedrooms on this side. Like, so three kids' bedrooms there. We'll have... this half bath or this full bathroom for the kiddos there, right? This can be the master bathroom. I'll make it have like a funky shape to it. Master bedroom in here, tiny kitchen here. That works. And then it's a 4-bedroom house. Aha, I'm a genius. I actually like that a lot. I think that makes sense. Okay, cool. And it's a weird shape. I like how weird shaped the rooms are. Because I think that makes sense for a house of this style, too. You know? Dining room is kind of huge. Yeah, that's okay, though. We could always, like... I don't know. I'll furnish it nicely. I like the big dining room. I can always do that, too, if it bothers you. Actually, that could be kind of interesting. I kind of like... how symmetrical it is. And then we have a little bit more space. Actually, no, I like the kitchen better being like this because it makes it, there's a more obvious position for cabinets. Weird shaped rooms are fun. I agree, weird shaped rooms are more fun. It makes the house more interesting, I think. I'm gonna get a 2-wide door. Where's the base game one? You miss spiral stairs? I think we all do. The good old days. Okay. I think that makes a big difference having all these doors like this. Nice. Okay, this bathroom's gonna be really tight, but it's gonna fit. It'll be so good. I like it. I like it a lot. It's gonna be so cute. Let's landscape then. Shower nook. Yeah, I'm gonna put a shower in here. It's this bathroom that I'm concerned about. This one will be fine because there's enough space with the extra, because I took away a tile by in this small bathroom by putting a 2-wide door. It's this one that I'm more concerned about. But it will be okay. And I'm gonna put like a desk sort of nook here. Because I closed that off too much. Needs a backyard garden. Yeah, I'm not gonna put stairs to the attic though, because the attic is tiny and the house is also tiny. Okay, but I wanted to put a wall around the front of the house. That was my goal originally, was to have a wall. I know that sounds dumb. I just want a wall, okay? It's all I care about. Why are these wall out? This is all base game. Hello? There you go. This wall is ridiculous and ugly. Oh, that works. That's better. Wall. Okay, perfect. I want the front of it to line up with... Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I'm a genius. I'll make the lot a little bit smaller than it actually is. I don't think it needs to even go all the way back. I know it does. That, like, defeats the purpose of the wall, but... It also doesn't need to go all the way in the front. Like, I could put the wall to, like, there, to be honest with you. So it encloses, like, the front of the build, but not the entirety of the build. Or even it could go, like, off from here. The key here is making the build not enormous, okay? Because then it looks ridiculous. Bigger is always worse. I don't know if I'll put something to block this a little bit so you won't see the connection between the wall and the foundation, but... Little Simsy is a weenie. Okay, Laura, that's really mean. I don't understand why you just attacked me. Hmm. Mike just attacked you too? I'm confused. What's happening? I'm scared. Fred at 11, thank you for the tier 1 sub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Scott says he loves my boyfriend. Oh, what if I put it up here instead? Even closer to the front of the build. That's too small. I want to make it even smaller. Bigger is always worse. Ah! Okay, I like that better. And we'll put a bunch of trees back here. And then the back of the house will also... Can I, like, do something weird? Like make it a funky-shaped wall? Like that? I can if I want. You can't stop me. Crow, thank you for the bits. I just want to start playing on the beautiful farm lot you built, but the gallery hates me. I'm supposed to be procrastinating. Anyway, love you, Kayla. And you rock. Hey, Crow, thank you so much. Also, the gallery has been down for a couple days, unfortunately. EA's been doing maintenance on it and stuff, so it's been in and out of online. But the gallery is down. It's not just you. Don't worry. Okay, I'm going to save my game. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. Oh, I want to use this tree. I love this tree. Yes. Okay, and then I can put a bigger one in the backyard. It's like they built this wall like around where the tree is. Honestly? Not bad. Can I put another one of these trees over here? Like, sort of there. Where they bury their dead pets. Maybe use some terrain tools. I already built the whole house though, Nikki. I don't know if I want to go back and add terrain tools now. This is what always happens to me. Like, I'll just start building without doing terrain stuff. And then, like, I built the whole thing now. I don't want to add terrain tools now. Yeah. Very good tree. You're welcome. Everyone, you're welcome. Famous Rec, thanks for the 6 months. Like a house that needs several pet dogs. Oh yes. Oh yes, absolutely. They do need many pet dogs. Or a willow tree, do you think? I think that'd be kind of fun to put a willow tree back here. I'm just wondering if, like, I never mix and match trees in my builds, like, too much. I also feel like that makes the backyard seem so busy, but the willow tree is nice, but it would be... Maybe the willow tree can go over here, and that's what they've got in the corner of their lot, is the willow tree. Again, this lot is backwards right now, in case you were wondering and worried. You're right, the lot is backwards. I know it is. I'm gonna put it back. The lighting on this lot is really bad, and I didn't want to build the front of the house with the bad lighting, so I rotated it backwards so I could build the lot with better lighting here. Because look, the lighting in the back is ugly. I don't think I can have that tree also. I think I need to only have the one. I do like that tree though. Let's just keep that for now. I won't put anything else in the backyard. Maybe I'll put, we could do some smaller trees as like organized landscaping though, and less like we could put this one in the corner with some plants around it. Like that's not too much, I don't think. You didn't realize it was backwards? Yeah. It is. I think I'll put a pond back here. Someone said it and I'm feeling it. With the camera around, I'm using the middle mouse button. I'm on the Sims 3 camera. Make sure you have this on. And you can do this. Pond. No, pond. Pond with little frogs. No, hang on. I'll just search and debug myself. Did I mess up? Did I type test engines enabled true? Artemis!
What is the best packs for building in The Sims?
Oh boy. My friend, Seasons. Possibly Cats and Dogs, but Seasons. I don't know, it depends. not common. We'll get like a not common fishing pond back here. See, I like the shape of the desert one better because it's got like more shape to it. It's not just like a big giant circle, but this one makes more sense. I don't want it. Should it go underneath the willow tree? Is that what needs to happen here? Actually, maybe that's like a vibe. It underneath the willow tree back there. I think it needs to be bigger though. I'll make the backyard one set bigger. Line the desert one with sand plants to match the sand. Sorry, I can't speak. I was just thinking that like I don't want to do that. I don't want to line it with too many plants to hide the sand. I'd rather just like make this one work, if that makes sense. No, I think that works for sure. That's kind of good. What happened to Builder's Bible? Nothing happened to it, Queensley. I've been doing a lot of like live Let's Build videos too, where I build in a video real time. And I think that sort of takes the place of Builder's Bible. Oh my god, the sun setting. See, it's always, there's like that second that it goes above. I mean, you know, it gets behind the trees and then it blinds me. And I'm gonna die, so I have to close my curtains. It always just starts. It's never a gradual thing. It's like, all of a sudden, it's right in my eyes. Right in my eyes. Okay. It'd be kind of hard to get back there. I might make it so I can fit a pathway. Preston is the sun. Preston is the sun. Oh, by the way, Discord partner, by the way. Discord partner, by the way. Okay. I'm glad you like the house. Thank you so much. Am I the bad guy? Yeah. Okay. I think I need more. I don't know what I want. Top girl. I went to get, I went to PetSmart the other day and saw the biggest good boy sheepdog ever. He looks exactly like Max from The Little Mermaid. I love sheepdogs. People who live in this house and that they would have a sheepdog. I think I agree with you 100%. You got ducks, by the way? I love ducks. I love ducks. Neve, then you have 9 months.
Twitch baby, what's the demon's name?
I might leave these open.
Also hope you're doing well today, Ellie.
Maximize the space. I'm doing great, thank you. Okay. I need to landscape for real, but I'm scared because my build is too big. Natalie, I just googled traditional English home to find this inspo pic. Didn't end up actually making anything like, well, it's similar, I guess, but it's not that close. I want to make the backyard like a more interesting shape. Like it needs to make sense. Like the wall needs to make sense, I think. I think that's fine. Maybe I'll put like, I don't know what I want to put in the backyard here. I think it needs to be a lot of, like, plants and stuff. But then I think it needs another tree. But I don't want to get, like, another giant willow tree. Maybe there could be a smaller little baby willow tree. Can I have a little baby willow tree? I can have a baby willow tree if I want one. You can't stop me. Because of the royal baby. No, not because of the royal baby. I didn't build a traditional English house because of the royal baby. Is that what you asked? Or baby, maybe the baby willow tree is in honor of the royal baby. Yep. Care so much about that. Can I do a well? Maybe. That's a good idea, actually. It was born on your birthday? That's so exciting, Bruin. Someone suggested a greenhouse, and I was kind of into that idea. But I also hate how glass roofs look so stupid and, like, dinky on tiny builds. I'm not doing it. I'm not. I can't. I'm not. It's gonna look dumb no matter what. I'm not doing it. The royal baby's name is Preston. You know, it won't be, but if it is, best day of my life. If he is. Sorry. Is that offensive? Are people upset that I call the royal baby an it? I'm sorry. Okay, I'm going to remove the foundation so I can landscape. Okay. Yep. Looks really good, Simsy. I'm so good at this. Okay. I'm gonna put some of these like I like to. Landscaping legend. Thank you so much. I'm a genius. I'm so good at this. I yawned, but it's fine, I got over it. How about these instead? 2-bit. Actually, oh my god. Adorable. I love putting tiny trees all sized down and stuff places. Maybe not those for now. I think, what if I use these instead? It's so small. I don't want it to be that small. How about the big, big ones? Oh, it's so pointy. That defeats the purpose, I think. I need something else. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. Okay. Well, I know I intend to use some of these flowers around the place a little bit. I don't know about how many of them. Also, how does it look sized down? See, they're so much better sized down. These flowers are enormous. Like, ridiculous. They don't need to be that big. They're much too big. I'm gonna make them some white and some blue, I think. Because I'm gonna put some of these flowers in blue. It's gonna look so pretty. I'm so good at this. Do I need to... I'm pretty sure you have a... Oh, they aren't blue and white. Oh, the yellow ones have basically white. Okay, well.
Sorry. I'd quote to say so. Yee yee.
Yee yee. Rika, thank you so much for the 16-month resub. What song of the Sims 2 soundtrack is this? I don't know. I'm listening to a giant video with only the Sims 2 soundtrack in it, so I don't know which song is which in the soundtrack, if that makes sense, because I just have, like, one big... Oh, it'd be cute to put this somewhere, but not in the front of this house. It's not, it's like too much, you know? I just wanted to get a bird bath. Yes. Okay, I can't change the color of him, otherwise I would. You know what I can do? I love ducks. Okay. I like that for now. I need to put another sort of plant. I guess these are good to put back there. Oh, it's pretty. I like this actually a lot. That's kind of nice. I probably should... Do I need to landscape around the side? Probably not. I need to landscape in the front. A duck is so fitting. Listen, we love ducks here on Lil Simsy. Mm-hmm. 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 a secret garden vibe. Yeah, I want the backyard to be kind of like that. I think the front needs to be a little bit more toned down. But, oh, I'm going to make it look so cool. Don't even worry about it. It's going to be so good. Okay. Oh, there's a lot of plants there. Well, can I put, like, a bush lining the back? Aw. How about this? All right, I'll put some bushes at the back there. Just so that there's more space. Simmer K. White, thanks for the 4 months.
It's my dad's birthday and I just had the most delicious dessert of all time.
Nice.
I love watching you and really appreciate that your streams are a safe place. Love you, Kayla. Happy 4 months.
Thank you, friend. Also, just for the same page, guys, I'm going to raise the foundation back up so that won't be clipping when I raise it up. It's just clipping right now. Although I could, I guess, is that already sized down once? How about that? they are already sized down ones, I think. I can't tell. They indeed are already sized down ones. But yeah, I'll raise the foundation back up and it won't clip like that, I promise. It looks like it will, but it won't even. It's gonna be so pretty. It's gonna be so nice. All right, I wanna get a, how about a sundial? Why not? Honestly, you know what? Sure. That's how they tell time here in the countryside. They don't have modern clocks or conveniences. So. Yeah, the sundial came with, I think, I don't remember. Ah, get to work. That makes sense. Yeah. Sounds about right. Okay. I want these flowers. Maybe I'll scoot you forward. And you forward. And no. And you over. And you down there. And maybe you over there. Can I get you in white instead? That's too light over there. I think that looks good. I need to put more of this. You want a sundial? That'd be kind of fun, wouldn't it? I like the vibes of this place. It's not get to work. It's, oh my god, it's get together. I say it every time I'm trying to talk about get together. I say get to work every single time. I know what I'm talking about. I say it, this, I did it earlier with the columns too. I know exactly what I'm trying to say. I just keep saying get together or get to work instead of get together. Every time. Every time. And so I'm not even confused as to which one is which. I just say the wrong thing on stream sometimes. It doesn't make any sense. Okay. I think I'm going to make the fence a little bit smaller so the pathway can be a little bit smaller. That path's gonna go up that way because it's gonna go outside of the house. I think I'm gonna scoot this forward on the lot, at least one tile. Too many gets. Too many get twos. Because it's not like get famous, it's called get to fame. You know, I think that's the problem, is that it's the get twos. It's stupid. They shouldn't have named them so close together. Actually, I might have that go, I'm gonna landscape more over here. I'm not gonna bring the pathway around yet. It should have been called Get to Fame. I think I agree. That's a way better name. Get Famous is stupid. I like that tiny tree. I think that's cute. Am I even allowed to think that's cute? Is it dumb? Probably. I kind of like it though. close the side and put a gate, maybe. Maybe I will put a gate. I don't know. Get to doing laundry. Get to the laundromat, maybe. They could have put a laundromat in. Call it Get to the Laundromat. I think that Laundry Day is kind of a dumb name, to be honest. Like, Laundry Day? Really? You know? Oh, I can do more of these. It makes it look so, like... Oh, that's probably too much, huh? I think that having them somewhere could be kind of cool. They're good in front of the house. We don't need them there, too. I think these are really cute. It's just like little bushes. Get to the city and start living. Can you imagine if they called it that? Get to the city and start living. Oh. Get to plane swatches. Sounds like a, yeah, it doesn't like a bad translation, doesn't it? Like, if they actually named it something like that, it just sounds like a bad translation and less like a real name of a pack. Which I think is kind of funny, to be honest, but... Get to spiral stairs. Maybe someday. No, they won't ever add spiral stairs in The Sims 4. I feel like I'm landscaping, like, so much. It's, like... Honestly, it's probably too much. Your mom got the ducks a swimming pool. They deserve it, okay? Ducks deserve the world. The size variations helps, I think. Okay. I think that's pretty. And obviously I'll put some terrain down. No. More color variation would help. But I want it to be all blue and white. It's a question of, like, maybe I need to make more white. Like, if I made these more white. But then it's, like, too little blue. I don't know. I think that more often than not, color variations make it worse. Maybe having these be, like, a more pinky blue color would be better. But, like, adding more colors, I think, makes it worse. Because it makes it look even more busy. At least the, like, monochromatic nature of it, monochromatic, that's wrong, but, like, I don't know. Maybe the pink helps a little bit. Nope, wrong. Oh, that tree from Pets, that's not a bad idea. I don't know if it would be too much, though. We're going a little bit wild here. You mean this tree? This would be so pretty, but I just don't know if it can. If I maybe can I make it like really small? No, I don't. Not on this one. I don't think. Unfortunately, I think I'm gonna make it more white. I just feel like the blue stands out way too much when I do it that way. But I think having more white will make it. No. Oh, the blue does stand out too much when I do it that way. Dang it! I don't know what to do about this. I don't like the purple, though. You liked the pinks? Okay, maybe I'll keep them for now. I might change... I'm sitting so low in my chair. I might change my mind. Who knows? Okay. Yes, mailbox. Hey, genius, thank you for the 2 month resub. mailbox. This one makes the most sense, but I also actually kind of like it. Kind of a vibe, to be honest. Ties in the purple. Okay. The white beech tree, not the... Oh, okay, sorry. You were talking about a different tree that got picked up by Automod. I know what you're talking about. You meant this one. Which maybe, but I like these trees. Like, I think that they're really pretty. Oh yeah, I haven't done the inside yet. The inside is completely empty. We're still trying to do the landscaping. It's taking us a bit. I'm going a little bit overboard with this build, so it's gonna be a while till I finish the build, I think. Am I building a cottage? A cozy English cottage in Windenburg. Okay, actually, when I rotate this around on the lot, this is gonna go... I was trying to, like, fade this out a little bit, but I don't need to, because it's gonna go up into, the edge of the lot on a sidewalk, because it's rotated backwards, so it's gonna go into this, so it'll be fine. It doesn't need to be like that. This is beautiful. Thank you. I never build like this, so I feel really out of my comfort zone right now. So I really appreciate you liking it, because like I said, this is very different for me with the landscaping. So I feel kind of weird. I feel like I'm out of my element. I feel like I'm like trying to be Avalyn Sims right now, and I'm just, you know? Okay. Do you think rocks? What if I like rock lined this pathway? I'm honestly, this could be too much gene coming out right now, but like, let me actually, I'm gonna rotate this back. I'm gonna put it, because we basically finished the front anyway. This is what it needs to look like, okay? If I rock lined this front bit, to be honest, it'll be a bit to finish it, but I think I made the first rock on the other side a little bit bigger. You second too much? You think it's too much? I don't know if it'll, like, can I try it?
There's a prom dress under selfies. Feel free to show the website photo to the peoples. You're deeply appreciated.
Oh my God.
For providing ourselves with homes.
Forever Dark Lake, thank you so much for the donation. Oh my God. You terrified me. But thank you so much for the donation. You're wonderful. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna try and line this. I think that the lining might help a little bit. And I'll only put it up to where the landscaping starts. I kind of like it. I don't know. I think that's... no. Line the plants? Ah, I'd rather not line the plants. I'd rather line the pathway more, but I don't like it. I won't do it. Storm, thank you for the 3 month resub. thank you. Also, I'd love to look at your prom dress, Forever Darkling, but I'm recording right now. And I'm recording my display capture. So if I have to like stop recording to pull it up. So maybe when I finish the landscaping, I'll look at it. But I wanna finish this one first. It's been an hour and 37 minutes of this build, and I've not even gotten close to finishing it. Okay, let's do something on the side of the house here, because I definitely feel like this needs to continue somehow and at least end up like over here, because I feel like it looks kind of dumb ending so abruptly, especially because I'm gonna put a pathway over here. I think the pathway needs something to follow. And I will give it that something to follow. Mark my words. Okay. It can even be kind of simple, like, simple, I say. Like, that much. That's all we need. It's so good. It's so nice. Okay. You would say a bridge over a river that goes under the house? You think a river on this side of the house and a bridge over it. I already have a pond in the backyard. I think that this lot, we have to like plan the house shape around it. And we didn't do it yet. You know, like I think if we're gonna build a house with a river around it, that can't be like an afterthought, you know? Like we gotta like plan the house around the river. You know what? We'll do a river house when I finish this one. I'm gonna put a well though. But like I like the idea of doing a house around a river, because that's always ends up looking really cool. We gotta like plan the house around it, you know? But I'll get us a river house. We'll make a river house. Don't even worry about it. We'll get our river house, guys. Okay. How long have I been live? I've been live for like 2.5 hours. Oh, Ravella, I'm so sorry. That sucks. Not fun. Not fun at all. Oh, when I rotated the lot? Oh! I hate The Sims 4. You know how terrain paint, like, shifts when you replace lots and stuff? Look at this madness. Do you see this madness? Honestly, it's shameful. I'm so disappointed in this game. How dare you? Okay, that's really annoying. That's really, really, that's why it's like hanging out this side so much, because it shifted. Okay. The wooden wheelbarrow from Get Together? Not a bad idea either. We're definitely going, like I said, a little bit overboard with this one, but that's okay. Overboard isn't always a bad thing. oh wait, it's not Get Together. That's in the base game, is it not? Is this what you're... Wait, are you talking about something else? Is that what you meant? Not that one? Let's look at the get-together items then. Were you talking about this? Probably not. Oh, this! Yes. Yes. Absolutely. Okay. Maybe I'll stick it, like, over here. You know, it fills up that side. Yes! Okay, I like that there, actually, to be honest. I think it looks really good. We'll get it in a lighter color. Yes! Am I running for president in 2020? Yeah, for sure. I meet all the requirements, like the age requirements and stuff. I'm old enough to run for president. SimCity 2020. Honestly, I don't think anybody wants that. Yeah, there is an age requirement. Yeah, you can't, I can't run for president. I'm not old enough. I look great for my age. Okay. You think I'm in my 30s? Are you serious? I mean, to be fair, for a person who's 35, like, I look really good. You know, you would never know. I don't look a day over 32. Okay. Oh my god. I've only voted in one election. I am a child. I most certainly am too young to run for president. I'm so sorry, guys. I know that I'm the change that we need in the world. Oh god, I do not want to run for president ever in my life. You know how when you're younger, everyone kind of like wants to be president when you're a kid. And you're like, yeah, I'll be president when you're like six. And then you get older and you're like, ah. Like, it's like how every kid kind of has that, like, I want to be a teacher, I want to be president. You know, like, you kind of, like, you never wanted to? Oh, really? Interesting. Did you have the teacher phase, though? Because I kind of feel like you just want to emulate the people that you see in your life, right? So you see your teachers, and you're like, wow, I want to do that. Wanted to win American Idol? I had a phase where I wanted to, I wanted to win, like, all the award shows. Like, I wanted a Grammy, I wanted an Oscar. I wanted it all. I had a phase where I was like, I'm gonna do it. But I didn't even know what those things were at the time. So, like, wanted to be a vet? Yeah, I think vet's a common one. You also want to be a doctor for a second. Like, all kids have that, don't they? I think everyone's been there. You wanted to be a singer, too? Yeah. I could never sing. I was never gonna be a singer. Police officer? Yeah. It's all firefighter too, probably. Like, just the things that kids, like, all those things are stuff that kids know more about. Because, like, I feel like most kids don't aspire to be, like, accountants, you know? But, like, you see, like, police officers and stuff like that, astronauts, and you, like, know about them and look up to them. Yeah. I had a marine biologist phase, too. I wanted to be a marine biologist for a while. Yeah. You wanted to be a TikTok star. Oh, boy. You're aging me? I don't know if you're kidding or not, but you're aging me? Or a princess? Yeah. And then you think more about it, and you're like, okay, but what even is that? You know? You wanted to be a mime? Oh, that's fun. But yeah, I wanted to be a teacher for a lot of my childhood. I think part of me still wants to be a teacher a little bit. Obviously, that's not happening, but maybe someday. Who knows? I always liked the idea of being a teacher. A paleontologist? Nice. That sounds like a fun one. Writer or a vet? Yeah. I had a friend in school that, growing up, she always wanted to be a vet. Always. Always. And you know how that's, like, one of those things where, like, a lot of people dream of being a vet when they're younger, but, like, do they actually end up being a vet? You know, like, because that's, like, sometimes your childhood dream is being a vet. That's pretty common, I think. But she's in school to be a vet right now. As far as I know, she could have changed her major. I don't know. She definitely applied to school that way. With that being her intention. So, I think that's kind of rare people, like, stick through with their, because, like, childhood dreams are childhood dreams, you know, like, you learn more about what you are signing yourself up for and stuff like that, you kind of change your mind, but, you want to be a dog, you know what, live your dream, you can do whatever you want, don't let anybody stop you. you weren't born here, so you want to be an artist? Fair play. That sounds like fun. Okay, I don't like this being this close to this here, so I now have to landscape the back of the house. That's so fun. You had a friend who wanted to be an artist, but she always hated art. Did she just, like, hate art classes, but enjoy art at all? Because sometimes, like, I think I understand the, because sometimes art classes almost, like, stifle creativity a little bit. I mean, it depends. Strong word. But, like, you know, maybe she didn't like the organized art classes, but wanted to make art or something. You want to be tall? Oh, she really hated art. She refused to color with you when you were, like, six. That's a weird thing. Imagine not... Okay, who doesn't like coloring? Everyone likes coloring. I'm bothered by this person. I don't like her. Who hates coloring? What kind of freak? Ross, thanks for the tier one sub. Woke up at 6 a.m. to watch this? Good. Should we get marker on her hand and throw a fix so that it was dirty? Okay. Interesting. You don't want to be tall? PSA from a tall girl? Okay, I think that there are pros and cons to being tall and short, okay? Like, maybe some things suck about being tall, but also there, things suck about being short, too. You can't win unless you're average height like me, in which case you win everything. I'm superior to all of you. Yeah, usually when we've talked about this in the past, I've said that the worst thing is to be average height, but I changed my mind. Average height is best height. Sucks for all you guys. Unicorn Gal, thank you for the bits. I wanted to be a vet or a teacher or Kim Possible or a singer, and the teacher part came first. Yep. I think that was my first thing that I wanted to do was be a teacher, because when I was in, like, kindergarten, I was like, teachers are so cool. Because it's the only, like, adults you ever interact with are your parents and your teacher. And I didn't understand what my mom did, so teacher was the move. My mom worked in finance and stuff. I didn't know what that meant when I was, like, six, so, like, didn't want to do that. Sorry, Mom. I'm going to create a sort of cutesy area. I'll put a table here and stuff like that. 5'2" squat is best squat. How about 5'5"? 5'4½. How about 5'4½? I say 5'5", but, like, let's be honest with ourselves for a second. That'll, by the way, raise up, so you won't be able to, it won't be hidden. The flower pot won't be hidden. Flower pot? Not quite a flower pot, but flowers. You're 5'5"? Nice. Good height. Does PewDiePie have legs? No. I know him. He's my best friend. He doesn't have legs, actually. You'd be surprised how many YouTubers don't have legs. It's actually illegal for YouTubers to have legs, so most of us don't have them. Yeah, poor guy, though. I don't have legs. I thought you said lice, not legs. I cannot confirm or deny whether or not PewDiePie has lice. He might have lice. Would you guys unsubscribe if PewDiePie had lice? Imagine if the idea of, like, a YouTuber getting lice and everyone being like, oh my god, you have lice, and unsubscribing. It's easy to get rid of? Well, yeah, but, like, PewDiePie has lice. I don't know. Yes, they have to make an apology video for their lice. Can you imagine? Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised at the internet for that, if they, like, shamed a YouTuber into making an apology video for having lice. Like, that... Or they just make it on their own for attention. They'd be like, I have a secret. I have a dark secret, crying in the thumbnail, and it's just, they have lice. PewDiePie is over party. He has lice. Everything else he did doesn't matter. He's got lice, though. So, like... What fence is that? It's from Get Together. It's pretty nice, isn't it? Okay, lice is a nightmare, yeah, but, like, it's worse than you think. I never had lice. Oh, if I get lice one day, I'm gonna be very upset. But I never had lice. I'm just saying, not to brag or anything, but, like, I'm not canceled. I never had lice. Not even as a kid, no. Thank God. I really wouldn't have enjoyed that at all. Obviously, but, like, thank God. It is common in kids, yeah. made it out alive. Remember in the office when everyone got lice? What a time. Yep, the office. How do we get to lice? I don't remember. But PewDiePie has lice and he's canceled. Better unsubscribe or else you're gonna get it. It's contagious. I'm spreading lies about PewDiePie right now. I'm gonna convince people that PewDiePie has lice for real. Can you? Sorry. The idea of that is really amusing to me for some reason. I don't know. I just think it's really funny, the idea of like trying to cancel PewDiePie for having lice. When he doesn't even have lice. But how do we know? He might have lice. Oh, sorry. I just imagined having lice in his beard and I was like, ugh. I don't know if he has lice right now, but like, imagine lice in your beard. Help. I'm sorry. Oh my god. Lice gum. That's such a good name for rice gum. Oh my god, you did that. You're a genius. We're calling rice gum that from now on. Oh no. Oh no, I did it again. Lice gum. I don't know why that amuses me so much, but it really does. Stupid rice gum. No offense, rice gum, but. We're gonna get him so good. Rice gum's gonna get really mad at me for starting that trend. And we're also in the same room as rice gum at VidCon. He had like a whole entourage. It was kind of wild. What a guy. I wish I was rice gum. No, I don't. Sorry. I have no desire to be rice gum, actually. I don't even know why I said that. I don't wish I was rice gum. No, thank you. Does anyone here wish they were rice gum? What a time. Unicorn gal, I had lice twice. This is off topic, but in sixth grade I took orchestra, can't spell, and I hated it, so I'd always skip the class. I never got in trouble for it because teacher didn't know my name. Oh, wait. You skipped class all the time in sixth grade, never got in trouble? That's kind of wild. I never skipped class in middle school. There were times in high school where I would go sit. I didn't like skip class, but I would go into the TV production room, like my video production class, and I would work on, because my senior year, I made the senior DVD, which was a very big project and took forever. So sometimes if I knew I wasn't doing anything in one of my classes, I would just go to that classroom and like, it didn't matter. And I would just work, so I would like do other homework basically, but like, didn't tell my actual teacher. Senior DVD, yes. Can't skip class at your school? I mean, you can't skip class at any school. You're not supposed to ever skip class. But like, it was, I don't know, I wasn't like, I don't feel bad about that still. I wasn't like skipping. Don't skip class though. If you're gonna get in trouble, don't do it. If you know you'll get in trouble, don't do it. I just knew I wouldn't get in trouble for it or anything, so. Skip class for a protest? Fair. Is Lil Simsy landscaping? Indeed I am. Shocking, huh? You never thought you'd see the day. Okay, I'm gonna leave that the way it is, I think. And I'll put some terrain paint down. I'm gonna spend this entire stream just doing this. Okay, cool. The build's getting close to being finished, I think, to be honest. Didn't skip class until college. Oh yeah, in college, I only ever skipped, there was one class that I had, my freshman year. Oh my god. This was genuinely one of the dumbest classes I've ever been in my entire life. Like, it was such a waste of time. It was a philosophy class, right? All of it was based on the reading. Like, everything was reading based, obviously, it's philosophy. So it's like reading like Plato and stuff like that. Reading about Play-Doh, the, like, toy, was the whole class. So, in the class, like, it was fine. It wasn't even that bad or anything. But, like, my professor wouldn't, like, figure out her lectures until she got to class. So she'd get to class and then decide what she was gonna lecture on. So she wouldn't, like, figure it out in advance and then come to class and then be like, all right, today we're talking about this thing. She'd get to class and be like, all right, we're gonna talk about today. And then just, like, go off on a tangent and talk for an hour and a half. And it was never on any of the exams. The exams were only about her, like, the reading. It was never about her lectures. So it was completely, like, class was completely worthless, like, beyond worthless. It was such a waste of time. Like, every time I would go to class and I would be like, why? And I had to go because she had pop quizzes. So she'd give a pop quiz based on the lecture the day before sometimes, but, like, it was random. It wasn't, like, every day. It was random. So, like, on Monday, she'd lecture, and then on Wednesday, she'd have a pop quiz at the end of class. So you couldn't just, like, leave early, and the pop quiz was on Monday's lecture. So you had to go to the lecture class because she would write the pop quiz about, like, what she talked about. And they were really easy pop quizzes, but, like, they were graded. And so that was how she made sure you went to class. But it was such a waste of time. Such a waste of time. Ugh. And, like, the thing is, I don't have time, like, not to be dramatic or anything, but, like, I don't have time to go sit for an hour and a half in her class, like, 3 times a week. Like, I was so busy, and I used to stream, if you guys remember back when I first started streaming, I only streamed 3 times a week, because I had her class from 4:30 to 5:45 on Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So I had her class, like, in the middle of my stream block, so I didn't stream on Mondays or Wednesdays or Fridays, because I had her class during that time. Helena, thank you for the 16-month resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And it used to just, it sucked so much. It sucked so much. I couldn't believe her. The fact that she would come to class and figure out her lecture that day. Sometimes she'd just, like, show documentaries and stuff. Like, not useful ones. Like, just, like. Anyway, got an A. It was really easy. And also because sometimes, like, there were days, like, around breaks where, like, everyone would just skip her class and go home early. But if you stayed there, and I always was just on campus, so I was like, I don't know, I've got nothing going on, I'm gonna go to class anyway. And on those days, because, like, 5 people would show up to class, she would sometimes give out, like, extra credit opportunities and stuff, so that was kind of fun. So I ended her class with, like, over an A. So that worked out well. I had, like, over 100 in her class when it ended. But, like, the fact that I had to go to her class so often and just sit there and do nothing, waste of time. Wasn't even in, like, her lectures weren't even that interesting. Like, it just was bad. And she also, I forget what happened, but, like, oh, it wasn't her fault. It was during the hurricane, freshman year. It was pretty bad around here. And so she lost power for, like, a couple weeks. And so she canceled class, like, for, like, a couple weeks straight once. So that was kind of fun. But then when we got back, it was, like, a lot of work to make up for it. But, you know. You print off a PowerPoint that she read off of, and she would add no extra content or anything. Super annoying. Ew. I don't get it. These people, like, imagine coming to class, though, not having any idea what you're gonna talk about. I couldn't believe that. Millionaire, thank you for the 9-month resub. Thank you, thank you, thank you, friend. But yeah, loved her. Missed that professor so much. Missing her every day. I forget her name. Wait, you got to go on a class field trip to a museum for free because she didn't know that you weren't a student? Oh my god. Yeah, she definitely didn't know who I was. I think she probably recognized me because I was always in class. And I would get to class early. Because I was paranoid. Like, not early, early, but, like, on time, a little bit early. And so I was, like, you know, around a lot. So she recognized me, and I was, like, turning in the extra credit she was assigning because it didn't take any time at all. She would assign, she gave out, like, an essay of extra credit once, but it was, like, 500 words. It was so easy, it was so fast to write. So I, of course, did it because I was like, I want the points on the exam. I think that was before her first exam, so I didn't know what it was going to be like. And she was giving out, like, if you did the extra credit, you would get extra points on the exam. And since I didn't know what her exams were gonna be like, I was like, I should do this extra credit because, like, I don't know, her lectures are garbage. I'm not learning anything. So, like, I gotta be careful here. Turns out I did not need the extra credit on the exam because it was so easy. Because she just doesn't know what, she doesn't even know what her class is like. She doesn't know what her class is about. That. I care too much about this. I just, that class, I, the fact that I, like, had to spend so much time there. I used to bring my laptop and, like, take notes on my laptop, and I would just sit on Discord the whole time, like, talking to my friends. Shameful. Will this build be on YouTube? It will be. I'm recording it, so it will go up on YouTube when I'm done. I'm gonna finish putting... You do that too? Yeah, because, like, I had to go for the attendance points since because she gave out the pop quizzes. So, like, if there was going to be a pop quiz, I had to go. I don't know. And also, we all know, I had a bit of a meltdown towards the end of, well, also, not even, it was towards the end of second semester, but also, late first semester. And so, one of the weeks, I went to class on Monday, and she only gave out one pop quiz per week. Here's the thing, right? So you could kind of, like, figure out, like, if she gave a pop, so she gave a pop quiz on Monday, so I was like, oh, well, pop quiz on Monday, she's not gonna have one on Wednesday or Friday. And so, and it's also, I think it was the week that Cats and Dogs came out. So I was, like, beyond busy, beyond stress, pre-recording and stuff, and, like, getting Cats and Dogs content out. And I was having a bit of a meltdown. it was just a bad time all around. So I skipped her class twice, that Wednesday and Friday, because I, like, couldn't, I just, you know, sometimes you just can't, you know what I mean? And one of my friends, roommates, was in my class, and, I'm gonna end the stream soon, by the way, but, she was in my class, and she used to fail everything, because she would go to class, not do any of the reading. Like I said, all the assignments and the quizzes and stuff were all based on the reading only. So she'd go to class, listen to the garbage lectures, never do the reading, and then fail the exam, because she didn't do the reading. And she just knew what she taught in class, and nothing was taught in class that was important, so it was just worthless going to class. So I skipped those two classes. My roommate goes, and she starts talking behind my back to my other roommates, being like, I think Kayla's gonna fail philosophy, she's failing philosophy, I don't know, she missed two classes, she's gonna fail philosophy, and, like, told people I was failing the class. I had over 100 in the class at the time. Like, I was not failing the class. She was failing the class. And I was so mad at her for that. And then we get our exam grades back, right? Professor passes the exams out, and, the girl is sitting in front of me in class, and so I got, like, a 95 on the exam, okay? Infinitely tired, thank you for the bits, hi, bees, and so left it sitting on my desk, because I knew that I was gonna do well, so I get my exam back, and I just left it on my desk, kind of strategically placed, you know? And then she gets her exam back, she literally failed the exam, and here she goes telling people that I was failing the class, you failed the exam! Anyway, so she turns around to, like, ask me a question, and my exam was, like, placed on my desk, you know, still sitting out, didn't put it away. And I saw her face when she looked at the exam, and I saw her face change, like a, like a how. Anyway, she was mean. She also had the mean racist friends and stuff. It was not, but yeah. Subtle revenge, you know? I just left my exam sitting out. I don't know. You didn't have to look at it. She looked at... Can you believe she looked at my exam grade? Plum Bob Dan, thank you for the bits. Odd question, but what is the plant in your background? It's pretty and I want one. I don't know what kind of plant it is. His name is Jeffrey. We talked about this. My mom gave it to me as a gift. I have no idea what kind of plant, what the name of the plant is. But yeah. Yeah, Bruin. It was. It's called a Jeffrey plant, yes. It's like a snake plant or something, yeah. I'm so sorry, Plumbop. Thank you for the bits. It's not a snake plant. Oh, okay. Yeah. I don't know. But yeah. She would say stuff like, Kayla's spending too much time on YouTube, she's gonna fail philosophy, she's gonna fail all of her classes. I have a full-time job and I'm in school and I still got A's. I don't know, I was really upset about that though, because like, I mean, granted I've complained about her now, but I never said a bad thing about her ever. And then she was acting, telling people I was failing classes. It's not her business to tell my roommates that, I don't know. Oh, I'm a hypocrite, I know, I'm sorry. She was mean. She did worse things, but I don't want to, like, I don't know. But yeah. Anyway. yeah, my roommates told me she said that, yeah, because they knew that it happened. Hold on. Anyway, dorms are kind of wild. I'm not gonna lie. Like, dorm living is kind of crazy. What a time. You just have, I think that having roommates, like, while living in a dorm kind of sucks, and, like, living with roommates that you don't know kind of sucks and stuff, I do think that it was a very good learning experience, you know? Like, I think that I'm really glad that I lived in the dorm. I also, like, I live pretty close, my campus is kind of close to my parents' house and stuff, like, so I, realistically, I could have probably commuted, and, like, it would have been fine, but I'm really glad that I stayed in the dorm, because I didn't like it at all. I hated it, but I think it was a good experience. Hey, Fear, thank you so much for the raid. I am so sorry. I was, like, gonna get off. But thank you so much for the raid. It's good to see you. How was your stream? Fear! I was just attacked. I was attacked. 3 months, 3. Hey, thank you for the 3 month resub. Can we get a caster in the chat for Fear? I hope you had a good stream. Hang on, I'll do it myself. I'm so scared. Oh, no, never mind. Brayden beat me to it. I got so good. Oh my god, wait. That fruit emote is really good, by the way. I'm not gonna lie. Also, I think your emote's amazing. I really like that emote a lot. That fear evil emote. Good stuff. But yeah, I was saying, like, living on campus was really good. Good experience that way. And also, like, living with roommates and stuff, it just teaches you a lot of things. It was helpful. I'm glad that I did that. Eliza, thank you for the Prime sub. Thank you. For those of you guys that just came to the stream, in case you don't know me, I'll show you really fast. I just closed my game. Never mind, I won't show you. I took a screenshot, though. Sorry about that. Okay. I built this house on stream today. It's sort of like a cottage kind of garden-y, magical, nah. Did I save? Yeah, I did. Don't worry, Bruin. But we built this today. We didn't finish the inside. We finished the whole outside, though. Pretty good timing, I think. I'm not sure who I want to raid yet. I want to see maybe if there's someone playing The Sims that I haven't raided in a long time. Hey, Pearl Blue Cookies! Thank you so much for 7 month resub! Yay,
7 months.
Thank you, friend. I don't know where I want to go. I don't know what I want to do. I'm scrolling. I'm looking. Ooh, this person, I don't know who they are. I've raided Little Sia a bunch. We could raid her. I like her. Let's raid her. You know what? Let's raid her. I know Deli's live right now, you guys, but I raided her, like, pretty recently. Like, I raided her, like, last week. But I think, I already said I was gonna raid. I know Deli's live, you guys, don't worry. But I think I'm gonna raid Little Sia. She's awesome. If you guys don't know who she is, you'll love her. She plays a lot of Just Dance. She is family friendly, mostly, I think. Big into The Sims as well, but she's so talented. She's got amazing blue hair. She's so cool. We're gonna go say hi to her. But yeah, when she plays Just Dance, she's amazing. Like, I just think she's the coolest person in the world. Like, I am so impressed by her. She's so good. If you don't know her, you're gonna love her. But she's playing The Sims right now, and she plays The Sims all the time as well. So go hang out. Eggs in the chat when you get there. Tell her I sent you, and tell her that we love her. And I'll see you guys all tomorrow. Thank you for hanging out tonight. Thank you again for the raid. Fear. Sorry to run. But I'll see you guys tomorrow. Like I said, I miss you. I love you. Okay, goodbye.